Good evening, fans. Welcome to the Area Championships. The Hooks Hornets take on the Dangerfield Tigers tonight's game. Brought to you by Nash Electric, C&D Mechanical, Alpha Stone, The Downtowner, and Texarkana Ag Holdings. It's playoff football in Texas. Ladies and gentlemen, we are here in Paris, Texas for tonight's area round matchup, Hooks versus Dangerfield. And Jay, to say that there's a lot of excitement about this game coming in would be an understatement for sure, and it is a capacity crowd here tonight in Pittsburgh.
Well, and so we don't cause a pileup out there, we're actually in Pittsburgh.
So what
not
I said?
Paris.
Did I say Paris? Man, what happened here?
Started with P. But no, it's a phenomenal night for high school football, where we're going to have the Hornets face the Tigers tonight. And I've been looking forward to this game all week.
Absolutely. And so we here at Texarkana Game Day, proud to bring it to you. I am Matt Frack, proud graduate of Hooks High School in 1999, joined by color commentator Jay Davis. And then Buddy Shelton is on the call with us. And Buddy, longtime Hooks fan, graduate of Hooks. You've been following this team all year. How excited is the city, you think, for this matchup tonight?
Well, first off, welcome to the show, guys. Thanks for having me on. Man, this city, the fan, it's electric. This team is special. They've done a lot of special things, and you know, hope to continue to keep doing some special things. So pretty much, the lock is locked. The lights are turned out, and everybody is here in Pittsburgh.
I was going to say, I think everybody from Hooks made their way down here. We talked about the Downtowner sponsoring tonight's game. Not sure too many people are there tonight, but certainly appreciate them for what they did. You know, this season started out, I think, a lot of expectations for Hooks as we started off. Had a really great season last year. And then early in the season, all of a sudden, Tripp Basinger, the starting quarterback, goes out, and there had to be a little bit of panic set in, and then Rip Birdwell comes in and – kept the trainer rolling, and here we are undefeated into the second round of the playoffs.
Right, and you know, we just had Rip on our show, on the sideline show yesterday. And, you know, it was sad, you know, when Tripp went down that first game against Harmony. But, you know, it didn't last long.
Yep.
Tripp didn't want us to be sad. Tripp told Rip to go in there and get it done, and that's exactly what Rip's done since he went in. He played that one last final drive against Harmony. Gave us the win,
yep.
And we are here now 10-0.
Well, Jay, go ahead.
He's definitely done it. He's coming in with 2,120 yards passing and 27 touchdowns through the air with only four interceptions, and he's also added another 467 yards on the ground and eight more. And any time that you have the opportunity to turn around and hand the ball off to Keyshawn Walls, that's going to take a little pressure off of you, even though you're a sophomore.
Right, and you talk about Keyshawn Walls, went over 5,000 yards this year. Of course, Hooks has had, you know, a few good running backs over the years, but Keyshawn, one of the more recent additions to the record books there at Hooks. And talk to us, Jay, a little bit about what this young man has done throughout this year.
Well, I mean, just this year, he's going to exceed 2,000 yards for the season tonight and 31 touchdowns for the season. And, I mean, that's just tremendous running on his part. Very, very good offensive line. And if that's not enough, Ripken's got 10 different receivers that he can throw the ball to. Jatavius Boogie Johnson, favorite receiver, 37 receptions. He's got 11 TDs through the air, averaging more than 21 yards a catch. Emmanuel Baird, also 29 receptions, 625 yards, 7 TDs, 21 yards a catch. So he's got some receivers that can extend the field.
Buddy, you know, Coach Birdwell back in the day, of course, Bubba played at Hooks, went through all that, kind of a tough-nosed guy. And that identity kind of comes into this football team. You talk to him, he has the gruff voice, he has that. Kind of talk about the grit and the determination you see from this this version of Hooks football.
Well, first off, Coach Birdwell runs a great program. You know, he went through the program in Hooks. So I think he going through the program and, you know, his coaching style, his dad was a great coach. His dad was never a school coach, but he was always a coach, young men, Little League football, Little League baseball. So he has got a tremendous, learning. I mean, man, he's just who he is. He's a great coach and he has pushed this into his program and the kids respond to it, you know, everybody wants to be a Hornet. That's, I mean, That's his bottom line.
All right. Yep. Hey, and he is celebrating something big tonight, Jay. Talk to us about the meaning, not only just trying to get a win here in an area round, but what about the meaning of tonight's game?
Well, tonight's his 100th game, and he is sitting at a record with 61 wins and 38 losses. He has only missed the playoffs one season since he's been here, and I believe this is his ninth season. And one of the things that that is going to be common from when he played to tonight, I went back and looked. When he played as a phenomenal linebacker for these Hooks Hornets, they averaged 12.08 points a game.
Yep.
This year's team is averaging 12.45 points per game.
Well, there you go.
So the toughness that he played with, he has brought it to this team. And, you know, it's just amazing what I've been able to see just in highlights of this defense. And it can't even it you know, but then you look at the offense.
Yeah.
I mean, Ripken steps in, Keyshawn. I mean, just, you know, it's going to be a fun night tonight.
And so we know about this. The Texarkana Game Day crowd knows about this. But this Dangerfield team that we're going to have showing up against us tonight, they're a pretty good team in their own right. Got a coach that's coming in. Of course, Arian Hampton, Bubba Hampton for them, highly recruited, going to the University of Texas. They've put together some successful seasons, a lot of history, a lot of tradition over there in Dangerfield, and I think that's where a lot of the talk kind of has happened this week. Other than being blue and white, these teams share a lot more things, and I think the love of their teams and the love of their city is one of those. And so what do you expect to see out of this Dangerfield team?
Well, I expect to see a lot of Chase Johnson for them to have any success tonight. He's also throwing over 2,000 yards passing, 26 TDs, only on four interceptions. He's got 462 yards rushing, 10 TDs. It's amazing how close their stats are for Johnson and Ripken, Birdwell. And so I think that offense is going to be placated off of what Johnson can do tonight against these Hornets.
And so, buddy, because of the familiarity with these teams, because of so much that's on there, there's been a lot of talk back and forth, most of it, in pretty good humor. How has that interaction been? I saw some guys down there with your face on their shirts and a Dangerfield hat on. Talk to me just about, you know, being fans in high school football and really how you think that helps, you know, get these kids excited for a game like this.
Well, you know, I think the week kind of started out kind of rough with the banter going back and forth. But as the week went on, it became actually kind of fun.
And we got your picture up here now with your hat on there.
Right. Yeah. I mean, we reached we had some of their fans reach out, asked to be our friends on Facebook, and even got some phone numbers and actually talked to them and laughed with them on the phone. And it kind of became a little meme war going back and forth. I think after about Wednesday – once we started kind of interacting with each other, it got really, really, really good. So it's just passionate people from passionate towns. And, you know, of course, we want our team to win. They want their team to win. And, you know, it's going to be two great football teams going at it tonight.
And so I think everybody's excited for that. You can see the Hornets coming out of the locker room, getting ready to make their way out here on the field. You can hear the crowd getting excited behind them once they make their way out here. We're going to have the national anthem. And I tell you, Jay, get the national anthem on a Friday night, a little bit of a crisp air, so much on the line, and kind of makes your hair stand up a little bit.
Well, and you said it right. The hair stands up. You can't ask for any better weather, and you've got two great teams tonight. It's just going to be electric. You've got the stands almost at capacity.
So here come the Hornets.
It's just going to be a very, very fun evening watching these two great teams play each other.
So here comes Hooks out there. You can see they've got the white tops on. We are the home team here over on the home side of this. White tops with the blue pants. Dangerfield in all blue out there. And, again, you can hear the fans and everybody excited to get this thing rolling here in just a few minutes. We're going to talk several times tonight, and we're going to mention them quite a bit, just the people that help bring this to you. Hooks is not on streaming every week. A lot of times, you know, there's just so much that goes on, and it does not happen unless people in the community step up and say, hey, we want to be a part of this. And so just like we did at the top of the show, we want to make sure we talk about National Electric, C&D Mechanical, Alpha Stone, the Downtowner, and Texarkana Ag Holdings. We can't do this, and Buddy, I know you went and talked to a lot of these folks out there in the community and said, hey, we want to make this special for our kids. We want to give them an opportunity for some exposure. And, man, people coming on board and partnering with us, that has to make us feel good.
Oh, man, it was almost too easy. I mean, it didn't – I talked to Morgan about it. Morgan told me what he would need, and I said, okay, So I kind of put a little plan together in my head how I was going to do this, and I wasn't sure how to do it, but I just said, you know what, I'm just going to ask. So I just kind of started with a little list of some people that I had, and I didn't even have to get it all the way out of my mouth. Sure, man, what do you need?
Yep.
What do you need?
And I think that says a lot about the Hooks community and really how much they feel about this. Well, we're going to turn it over to the stadium PA announcer, and we're going to have tonight's national anthem.
We ask you to please stand and kindly remove your hats. Give your attention to the west end of the field as we prepare for the playing of the Star Spangled Banner, which will be played by the Hooks Hornets Band. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the playing of our national anthem.
There's our national anthem. It's a little bit quiet. Sorry about that, folks. The band set up as far away from our microphone as possible.
We would like to direct your attention.
If you were at home and thinking maybe there was something going on with your TV, probably wasn't that. As we get ready for the coin toss,
the
Hooks Hornets sending out Emmanuel Baird, number 55,
number 3,
Kaysen Schott.
Number
6, Braden Doyle.
Kelly.
And number 13, Logan
number 11,
Baker.
Alan
coming out for Dangerfield. Number 11, Island Boyd.
Number
3, Braden
Logan
Lewis.
Baker.
Number 12, Jaqueline Kelly.
Baird.
Number 10, Tristan
Kaysen
Martinez.
Chote.
So we'll
and
see
6,
what each team
Braden Doyle
decides to do here as we get the coin toss off. And Jay, both of these high-powered offenses, I wouldn't be surprised if whoever wins wants to keep the ball, which means if that's what I think, they'll probably do the opposite.
There's a reason why we're up here. Not on the
absolutely.
Place you and both your can survive.
So the referee has, and again, you can see in some of our crowd shots, of course, you can see across the way there in this one, you've got
Kennedy
just a capacity crowd here in Pittsburgh. And, man, how many people are excited to see this game
tails
get kicked
is
off.
Tails call from Dangerfield.
Dangerfield calls tails.
It is heads. Hooks
and Hooks wins the toss. Hooks will decide how to go.
Hooks is receiving.
And so the Hornets are going to receive. And so, buddy, we're going to see this offense try to get rolling first thing.
Yeah, you know, these guys, they come out on fire every week, and I think they're glad they won that toss, and they want to show that.
And so Hooks will start on offense. They'll be going from our right to left on your screen. Dangerfield coming from left to right. And, again, a little bit confusing. You see all this blue out there. Hooks wearing the white tops tonight here at home. Kind of like the Cowboys do, Jay.
High school football.
And Dangerfield in all
but as
blue.
Spectators, let's all remember
well, Texarkana Game Day is excited to be able to pull this stream off tonight. And for those that are watching, let us know where you're watching from. We're definitely glad that you're here. And so we hope you enjoy the game as much as we anticipate that we would.
Absolutely. I think they said we already got more than 1,000 people on the stream, and so we're excited to see that between Facebook and YouTube. I want to make sure that we can see everybody there. Tigers have the ball teed up right in the middle of the 40-yard line, and Jay, as number 18, Jonathan Solis has it teed up. I want to bet that young man plays soccer also because he's got some bright lime green cleats on. Carvion Johnson back deep for the Hornets, as well as number 8, Emmanuel Baird. 10, Rod Bailey. They're the two men all the way back deep.
Emmanuel Baird.
Well, I definitely like the green kicks.
Yeah, them are some bright, shiny kicks.
They are. You can see them from here. So that's Solis. We'll see if he goes for a deep kick, tries to keep it short.
That's
a little short Maverick-style kick. We're going to have a fair catch at the 35-yard line. That's number 18, Jasper Crane for the Hornets. And so Hooks will have a good starting position here, starting first and 10 at their own 35-yard line.
The ball will be placed on the 35-yard line.
Hey, just real quick.
Hornets will have the ball first down and 10.
What is it with kickers
for their first
different
position
color sheets
of the ball game?
Well, you know, you have to be a little different. And sometimes you just need to get a little extra lime light.
So yeah. The sophomore, Ripken Birdwell, brings him out. Two receivers to his right side, one to the left side. Single back is Keyshawn Walls. And now they move a receiver over to the left side. Walls gets the handoff. He's going to be hit right at the line of scrimmage, bottled up by the middle of that Tiger defense. No gain on the play.
Yeah, Bryson Lee steps up and just creates a wall. He has 121 tackles so far this season.
And Boogie Johnson, a little bit shaken up over on the left side of this formation. Not sure if he was involved in a block or what, but he was a little shaken up, but he's coming off the field now, got his helmet off. And might have been something a little bit extracurricular going on over there. You can see Coach Birdwell already talking to the referee about it. And Boogie was a little fired up when he came off as well, so I'm interested to see how that develops as the game goes on. Second down and 10. It'll be second down and 11. Actually, the ball goes back to the 34-yard line for the Hornets. Birdwell coming from the coach over to the sideline. There'll be 10 seconds on the play clock when he brings them out of the huddle. Now we're down to 6 seconds, and they're going to have to get moving a little bit here. And Hornets are going to have to call a timeout. There's a little bit of some confusion in whatever happened with Johnson there, and I think that had him get out of the sideline huddle a little bit late, and so maybe the Hornets just needing to take a second to get things straightened out and make sure everybody's on the same page.
Well, and hopefully it was just a little pride there early in the game. And, I definitely anticipate a little chippiness as much as this is just going to mean to each of these communities. And as long as it just stays clean, hey, let's have a little talking about how we just did on that play. And
you expected on the first couple of series is to be really, really chippy with these. You know, these guys, it's the second round of the playoffs.
Yep.
And, they poured a whole season into this, and nobody wants to go home. So,
lots of talking all year long.
Returning to play, 11:23 remaining in the
after the timeout
quarter.
Now, the Hornets back at second down and 11. Down. Everybody in tight now. Two receivers just outside the tackles on either side. Birdwell now sends a man in motion over to his left to send three over there. He rolls out, wants to throw, and he's going to be brought down in the backfield. Didn't have anywhere to go down the field. Bryson Lee,
number 11,
able to get back there and bring Birdwell down inside the 25 at the 24. And that's one of those that I think part of the credit goes to the secondary, part of it to those guys up front. Lee able to get back on there before Ripken could get that ball out. It'll be third down and long now for the Hornets.
Yeah, they had good coverage there on Boogie Johnson, and Ripken just decided to go ahead and keep it rather than trying to force that pass in there. But that was Bryson's third sack of the season.
Three receivers to the left side now, one to the right side. Birdwell wants to throw, looking right, firing down the field. Incomplete. Up out of the hands of the intended receiver, Baird, was a little bit high.
Jorge Velasquez.
Might have been Velasquez, the intended receiver.
Brings up a fourth down.
No, fourth down, the Hornets will send in presumably the punt team.
Yeah, that'll be Jasper Crane coming in to kick. You know, he was put up for, I think it was the Whataburger, Texas kicker punter of the week a few weeks ago.
Oh, wow.
On the Dave Campbells.
Well, we'll see if he can get a good kick here. Punting from near his own 15-yard line. Line drive takes a good Hornet bounce at the 40. It's going to roll down inside the 30 down to the 28-yard line. And so that's where Dangerfield will have it first and 10. The Hornet defense making their first trip out there. And so
a
little bit slow to get going for the Hornet offense here.
Of the Tigers.
Well, now we wait on Chase Johnson and company.
Yeah, we're about to see what Chase Johnson is about.
For their first possession of
he's
the game.
Going to start 72 yards away from the end zone for a possible score. So it'll be interesting to see what Coach Nelson has right off the bat for these Dangerfield Tigers.
The Tigers will scrimmage from their own 28-yard line. Spread formation now. Two receivers out on the left side. One man by himself on the right side is Hampton. Johnson with the snap. Hands off to the tailback trying to come in the middle, and the Hornets wrap him up quickly. No gain on the play for Braden Lewis. Rod Bailey coming up to make the tackle for the Hornets.
Yeah, I think also Jasper Crane, the 8-6s and zeros are tough to distinguish.
I'm getting the straight, so that is Jasper Crane.
Far up.
Yeah, that's right. That is Jasper up there in the middle.
2-yard pickup, second down and 8 to go now. Two receivers split to each side. Quarterback wants to throw. Fires into the middle of the zone. Has an open receiver. He'll have just enough for the first down up to the 39-yard line.
Tigers.
That was Mason Williams on the reception. The Hornets do have a man a little bit slow to get up out there.
And that is Minter, and he was the initial Hooks Hornet who hit the running back to bring him down. Hopefully he'll be able to get up under his own power here shortly. Coach Birdwell pulling the team together to talk about things.
They're out there going to check on him for just a minute. Trying to decide if we'll tell you what, we're going to take a timeout with him. You're watching Hooks Hornet Football on Texarkana Game Day.
We are excited to announce here at Texarkana Emergency Center and Hospital that we have expanded our capabilities to better serve our community. As a hospital, we have the capability for inpatient services. After your outstanding emergency care, we can smoothly transition you into one of our new inpatient rooms that have telemetry monitors in every room to continue your concierge medicine care. While our patients continue receiving their care in their inpatient suites, we also make sure that your loved ones are taken care of with our outstanding facilities. Our added services include a procedure room and also the capability of MRIs. With our imaging, we are able to offer outpatient, inpatient, and emergency room MRI, CT, ultrasound, and X-ray. We are honored by your support and look forward to serving all your future medical needs.
Life is busy, and we get it. The State Bank mobile app was designed to make banking more convenient for you.
Check account activity, make transfers, pay bills, and manage your debit card in a snap. You can deposit checks from the convenience of your home or wherever life lands you.
The State Bank app lets you organize your accounts, manage alerts, and easily email our customer service experts. Now that you have State.
All right, folks, welcome back. And you can see R.K. Minter able to make his way off the field, and they had him down there for a minute. Really, I think, just trying to take all precautions to make sure he was good before he moved around. I think he may have indicated maybe something above the shoulders there, a little bit of pain. And, man, that's when those trainers and those folks do a good job. So it'll be first and 10 for the Tigers now after the injury timeout. They're at their own 39-yard line. They're going to have everybody in tight with two receivers to each side. Man in motion. There's going to be a flag on play. Somebody got moving just a little bit early. They were trying to get Kenny Mosley around the right side. And a false start's going to back the Tigers up 5 yards back to the 34-yard line.
Yeah, unfortunate there. Kenny able to take that little jet sweep on the motion, and he was hitting top speed there once he got the ball.
Yeah, it looked like he had a head of steam behind him. First and 15 now for the Tigers. And, again, the same formation, everybody in tight. We'll kind of go a multitude of directions from this. Fake the handoff. Quarterback wants to throw as he's looking down the field. Firing deep, and it is caught. Bubba Hampton on the reception. And he is all the way down to the Hooks 25-yard line. It'll be first down and 10 for the Tigers from there. And that's one of those where you can tell the quarterback and receiver have done that a few times because he knew exactly where he needed to put that ball. Now using some tempo, the Tigers back to the line. Three to the right side, one to the left side. Quarterback hands it off. Little read option. Johnson, the last moment, let it go into the gut of Braden Lewis, the tailback.
Yeah, Braden's got 592 yards rushing and averaging 7.89, and that's about what he got on that play.
Tigers have the ball down to the Hooks 18-yard line. It'll be second down and three to go now. Three receivers over on the left side of this formation. One man by himself on the right side is Williams. Chase Johnson gets the snap. He wants to throw, looking right, going toward the corner of the end zone. Going to be too much. Bounces at about 5 yards over the back corner pylon. It'll be third down now for the Tigers.
And not necessarily a bad decision there. Looks like the receiver was covered, so he just threw it where no one would be able to come down with it.
Third down now for the Tigers. You feel like they may be in four down territory here, being third down and three. From the left hash with three receivers on that side. Handoff once again goes to Lewis. He cuts up into the second level of the Hawks. So that was Williams on the carry that time. Gets down to the 13-yard line of the Hornets. First and 10, Dangerfield.
Yeah, this is when Hooks is going to get into that bend, don't break defense to try to keep these Tigers out of this end zone.
Dangerfield now trying to spread the Hornet defense out. Three to the right side, one to the left side. Quarterback keeper the whole way on a designed run, and it goes nowhere. The Hornets back in the backfield. Logan Baker, the first man. It's his 87th tackle, 18th tackle for loss on the season. And the quarterback Johnson has dropped back outside the 15-yard line to the 17.
Yeah, defensive coordinator dialed up a great answer there to that play, and here we have basically the first negative play for Dangerfield tonight, minus the penalty. Definitely want to give thanks to all those that are watching.
Yeah, it looks like we're at 1,000 or so. That's a lot of people.
Second down and 13. Now got a flag on the play. A little bit of motion beforehand, and the Tigers, you know, he backed up five more yards. This will put him outside the 20. I do realize if they, I don't know if they commented on there. I did say Hawks a minute ago. That's my fault.
Well, that's all right. You've got a Hawk sitting next to you, and you've got a few Hawk fans that are on the feed. I do know that there's a special trio, class of 92, that definitely is behind the Hornets tonight. Mr. Daly, Mr. Naples, and Mr. Nallen. So, Pleasant Grove in the house a little bit tonight.
Tigers wanting to throw once again out to the left side. Little out route and a little bit too far in front of the intended receiver from Johnson. He was trying to connect with Kenny Mosley, put a little bit too much on it, and that's a couple of times that Johnson just put a little bit sauce on it. And so now it's third down and long, 18 to go for the Tigers.
Or it will be towed in 15 minutes.
We're inside of 7 minutes in the first. Two receivers to the right side, two to the left side. I don't know if y'all can hear the stadium. There's going to be a false start again. The left side of the formation was moving, and this Hornet crowd is steadily getting louder. I think they're trying to impact what's going on out there.
I was trying to listen to him because I was trying to make sure that wasn't my
make
car.
It wasn't, yeah, he said somebody's car's there. He said if it's there in 15 minutes, it's going to be towed. You're going to come out, and it's going to be gone.
Well, and that's another benefit to watching the stream on game day. You are not going to get your vehicle towed.
No.
That's right.
Third and 23 now for the Tigers when they break the huddle after the false start penalty moves them back to the 26-yard line. Three receivers will be to the right side, two on the left side, an empty backfield for Chase Johnson. Hornets secondary. Be a good place for a turnover here. Johnson drops back, wanting to throw, firing into the middle. It is caught. Touchdown. That is complete to Braden Lewis.
Oh.
A little extracurricular activity. There'll be a flag after this. I tell you, that time Johnson put the ball exactly where it had to be. Lewis was not standing alone. He had some Hornets around him, and that ball just dropped right into where it had to go.
Yeah, Chase just had a lot of expediency on that ball.
Now we wait on the extra point. It is a personal foul against the Tigers. They're going to march it off on the ensuing kickoff. So a taunting penalty against Braden Lewis will back Dangerfield up, and so the Hornets will have an opportunity for a short field while we wait on the extra point attempt from the Tigers. Is that number 19 out there?
I believe that is 18.
18. I was gonna say, I don't have a 19 on here. That's Jonathan Solis. Snap is down. The kick is up. It's good. 6:32 remaining in the first quarter. Tigers strike first, 7-0. Dangerfield over Hooks. We'll take a break. You're watching Hooks Hornet Football on Texarkana Game Day.
Whether you're looking for a new or pre-owned car, truck, or SUV, or maybe a new or pre-owned boat or RV, care for a car wash, had a fender bender, or you need service on your vehicle, boat, or RV, we have it all when you let us exceed your expectations at Greg Orr Auto Marine and RV in Shreveport, Texarkana, and Ashdown. Shop hassle-free and always be treated like family while choosing from our sensational selection. In Shreveport, visit Orr Acura, Orr BMW, Orr Cadillac, Orr Infiniti, and the Greg Orr Pre-Owned Supercenter. In Texarkana, Mercedes-Benz of Texarkana, Classic Buick GMC, Classic Cadillac, Classic Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram, Classic Kia, Classic Mazda, Classic Pre-Owned, the Classic.
All right, folks, welcome back here to Pittsburgh. I do want to once again thank the sponsors of tonight's game, Nash Electric, C&D Mechanical, Alpha Stone, the Downtowner Restaurant, and Texarkana Ag Holdings. Without them, we could not bring you this game tonight. After the 15-yard penalty, the Tigers will be forced to kick this off from their own 25-yard line, and we'll see if Hooks can take advantage of this. Emmanuel Baird standing back near his own 25-yard line, along with Rod Bailey, waiting on this kick. If they kick the same kind of kick they did to start the game, the Hornets will be starting inside Dangerfield territory. Solis has the ball teed up right in the middle of the field.
I believe Green Shoes is going to try to go deep.
High end over end kick. And the Hornets are going to fair catch it just inside the 40 at the 38-yard line. That's Emmanuel Baird coming up. Take that one in. And, Jay, I think he might have been able to get about 4 or 5 yards or so, but sometimes you make a business decision when you see the other team flying down there towards you.
Well, and, I mean, normally when you're standing at the 40-yard line and the kick comes to you, you're going to fair catch it.
Yeah.
So, not realizing maybe that he had an extra 10 yards or so that they had to run. But business decision. Not bad.
Hornets back out on the field now. Hand the ball off to Keyshawn Walls, trying to come left. He's going to cut it back up into the formation. Walls gets very close to first down yardage. We'll see where they mark his progress. It is enough to move it. First down Hornets at midfield. Now Hooks using some tempo with two receivers to the left side wide. Walls again coming left. Just off tackle, following some of those big blockers up in front of him. This time he picks up 3 yards. It'll be 2nd and 7.
Yeah, we're going to see a lot of Keyshawn Walls tonight. Just an explosive runner. Anywhere from, I guess, maybe about 34 more yards, and he's got 2,000 for the season.
Hornets now spreading the receivers out. Walls again. This time the Tigers converge in the middle. Bottle him up after a short gain. It'll be 3rd and 5. Marlon Haynes, big number 77, defensive lineman for Dangerfield. He came into tonight's game with 91 tackles. Hornets again on the move. Caught underneath. Emmanuel Baird. He's brought down hard, but not until he gets enough to move the sticks once again. It's 1st and 10, Hornets at the Dangerfield 40. Baird doing a great job to hang on to that football.
Yeah, the last four yards were all him, and very, very tough running there after the catch for a first down for Hooks, continuing to move those chains.
Hooks still with tempo now. 3 to the right side, 1 to the left side. Birdwell gets the snap, fakes to Walls, throws, caught by Boogie. Boogie makes the first man miss, and he's at the 40. Boogie jumps over a defender, and he's going to be all the way down at the 32-yard line. It'll be 2nd down and 2. Trent Boyd comes over to make the stop. But Jatavius Boogie Johnson showing off his athleticism. 2nd down and 2 now. The Hornets need the 30 for a first down.
It's okay, man.
Man. It's still weird to say Hawks when I graduated from Hooks. I'll just be honest with you. Birdwell wants to throw. Rolling to his right, and it is caught. And I tell you what, that is a great heads-up play by Jasper Crane. That's number 10. Man, these 8s and 0s. Rod Bailey. That ball was nearly intercepted. Bailey kept his hands there and not only prevented the interception, but was able to pull that ball in.
Yeah, Trent Boyd was thinking pick 6 for a little bit, but just was not able to bring the ball down.
Now I think the discussion is going to be, was it a catch and a step out of bounds, or was it an incomplete pass, and we're still at the original line of scrimmage. So they're going to say he touched the ball out of bounds. It's 4th down, 4th and 1, and the Hornets going for it here.
They're going to reset the clock, too.
And, Buddy, yep. I'm assuming this goes to Keyshawn?
You know, me being just a fan, I say give it to him.
They're trying to get 4:25 back on the game clock. There we go. Got the clock set here in the stadium. Yeah, and it's 3rd down and 1. I was trying to figure out how the Hornets lost a down. I thought maybe it had something to do with being out of bounds, but it is 3rd down. 3rd and 1. A bit less implication than 4th and 1. Walls does get the handoff, though, as he tries to come left. He's going to have enough for the first down and more. All the way down near the 25-yard line, Keyshawn Walls, and that time, Jay, did a good job of being patient down the line, and as soon as he saw a hole where he could get north and south, he got that pad level down low and dove in for the first down.
Yeah, and I think that's just what we're going to need to see of him tonight, just have a little bit of patience, trust that line to open that hole up.
3 receivers now and a bunch on the right side. Birdwell rolls to his right, wants to throw, fires a little bit high. Boogie catches it. I think that one took a little bit too much time.
As is complete.
And Boogie will lose a
14, Jatavius Johnson.
Yard on the play, but by the time he was able to come down with that ball, there were several blue jerseys around him.
Well, it looks like you're in good hands, buddy, because it looks like Sheriff Jeff Neal stayed in town, and he's watching our stream tonight, so he may be keeping everything safe with everything locked up and lights out.
That's right. He's keeping everything safe down there in Hooks.
Second down and 12 now for the Hornets. They flip the formation and send three to the left side. Dangerfield showing pressure. Birdwell pump fakes left. Firing down the field, incomplete, and he had a man in his face. I think he couldn't quite get enough zip on it. Trying to get it down to Johnson, and I tell you, Boogie was in a great position if Birdwell was able to get the ball there, but I think he just had a defender shoved into him. Bryson Lee doing everything he could for Dangerfield to disrupt that one in the backfield, and now it's third down and 12.
Yeah, just throwing off that back foot, just did not have enough arm to get it all the way back there to Boogie, but I expect him to go back to that play a little bit later this evening.
Third and long for the Hornets now. Ball rolls back, and Birdwell's going to be brought down in the backfield. I don't know if there was a miscommunication there with the center or what exactly happened, but the ball rolled back. Braden Lewis is able to get back there and bring Birdwell down, but had to reach down and pick the ball up, and now it'll be fourth down and about 16 to go.
Yeah, that's unfortunate. I don't know what happened, but that just busted the whole play up right there.
Fourth and long. The Hornets behind the sticks here. They're going to empty the backfield. Three to the left side, one to the right side. Big play coming up here early. And looks like Dangerfield may want to talk about it. And they do. We're going to take a timeout with them. You're watching Hooks Hornet Football on Texarkana Game Day.
Long enough to achieve your dreams. At Texarkana College, now is your time to train for a new career or earn a college degree.
I got a fresh start at TC.
I didn't know where to start until TC.
It was finally my time to start at TC.
I'm finishing when I started at TC.
Texarkana College, it's your time to start or start over.
So after the Dangerfield timeout with just under 3 minutes in the first quarter, the Hornets come out fourth down and 15 to go. Ripken Birdwell looks into the defense from an empty backfield. Looks to his left, looks to his right, firing down the field, incomplete. Trying to connect with Velasquez, he's unable to pull it in. So the ball will go over on downs. And so a Hornet drive that showed some promise. They were able to move the sticks. And a couple of unfortunate plays put them behind the line there. And ball goes over to Dangerfield. First and 10 Tigers at their own 31-yard line.
Well, and I think the defense just needs to tighten up a little bit here and get the ball back for Ripken to go down and score to level out this game. Definitely don't see anything uptight about the players or any you know pressure. So still early in this game.
First and 10 Tigers. Chase Johnson and company will scrimmage from the 31. Single back formation. The tailback Williams gets the handoff. He goes around the left side, gets up to the second level of the Hornets. He'll be knocked out of bounds by number 13, Logan Baker. Williams will have enough for the first down, gets it up to the 42-yard line, first down and 10.
Yeah, Logan Baker comes in tonight with 86 tackles so far for the season, 17 of those for loss.
Tigers with three receivers bunched over on the left side now, one single man to the right. Quarterback rolls to the right, one to throw. There's a flag on the play. The pass is complete. temporarily to Hampton. We'll work out the flag here. Looks like it's going to be on the Tigers. Probably a chop block.
Yeah, they got 13 Logan Baker pretty good on the chop block.
Yeah, Hampton saw that when he caught the ball. He didn't make any moves to extend that play. He knew it was coming back.
And you hear they call it against two. Anytime you have somebody engaged, you can't take their legs out. And so the personal foul will march off 15 yards against Dangerfield. You can see Baker, and you talked about how hard they hit him there, buddy. He's a little bit ginger out there moving around, but toughing through that.
Yeah, Logan, man, you know, he came in as a sophomore and has played ever since, and he's a really tough kid.
Williams wants to throw again, firing into the middle, and that is caught. He had some sauce on that, and Amarion Simeon-Jones just jumped up, pulled it down at the 45-yard line, picked up the penalty yardage and about five more. They bring up second down and seven now.
Yeah, Kaysen May had to come back out of his linebacker spot to make that stop, and he added another tackle to his 26 so far for the year.
Second down for the Tigers out of a single back set. Lewis gets the handoff, and he is rocked at the line of scrimmage. Doesn't get far until he runs into a host of white jerseys. First one there, big number 64 for the Hawks, Ransom Jones.
And for the Hornets, number 18, Jasper Hornets. Crane came in to clean that up.
The H names are messing me up. It's like in my head now. I'm sorry, folks. I don't even know what to tell you. I don't know what to tell you. Golly, I got to get it.
Well, we know you're a Hornet at heart.
So. That is 100% true. Two receivers to each side now. Williams fires left, picks up a block. The receiver's on the move. That's Kenny Mosley out there, and just a little wide receiver screen. Birdwell comes over to make the tackle. Mosley has enough for the first down, down to the Hornet 36-yard line.
Yeah, just good eye there for Johnson finding Mosley open, and just good after the catch yardage there by Mosley.
Two receivers split to each side. Johnson throwing left. And the receiver coming back across the formation, almost like a little zoom sweep. And that's Hampton.
Yeah, that was a very neat play. I think it was really designed that way.
Yeah, I think you're probably right.
Well, thankfully, Ransom Jones stayed on the other side, I believe, and was able to at least force him out of bounds before he got first down yardage.
But yeah, but I mean, it really just looked like a long zoom sweep, but they threw it over to the right side. So, yeah, a little gadget play there, and it's second down and two to go. Ball inside the Hooks 30-yard line down to the 28. 38 seconds left in the opening quarter. Tigers up 7-0. They break the huddle. Two receivers split to each side now. Johnson drops back, flag on the play. Somebody probably got moving just a little bit too early. It'll be a delay, and they stood around for quite a while, Jay. I thought they may be taking it down to a timeout or trying to burn some time off the game clock.
And I have not seen an injury due to delay a game, but we do have a Tiger that is down on the field.
And maybe they were trying to wait on him to get straight. Not sure, but, yeah, had a delay of game penalty and then had a young man go down there. So we'll back up 5 yards. I don't think that takes the 5-yard penalty off the board in a few.
No, and, you know, penalties have stalled this drive a little bit for Dangerfield, but then they able to overcome those. But, you know, you start shortening this field, that definitely goes towards the defense. And Dangerfield probably getting themselves in some trouble here with penalties like this on delay of game that definitely aren't called for.
Right, yeah, you don't. As always, it's good to see those are the things that I know drive coaches crazy because those are the things that are preventable. I can tell you we got a lot of Hornet and Hawk fans watching because they're getting a kick out of me getting stuff mixed up. Oh, I'm going to try to get better. Tigers second down and seven. The ball at the 34-yard line. Two receivers split to each side for Chase Johnson. He hands the ball off to Ashton Williams. Williams comes left. He'll have enough for the first down, brought down at the 25-yard line.
Brought down by the Hornets, number 30.
Kaysen May, the sophomore running back, defensive back, came over to make the tackle for the Hornets. But it is enough to move the chains, first and 10, Dangerfield at the Hooks 25. And that may be.
Yeah, I think the play clock is a little ahead of the – or the game clock's a little ahead of the play clock, so
yeah, we'll
that's
going to
wind out that.
If they snap it or not, they don't have to.
They look like they are.
And they do. Little throw underneath. Caught. They're trying to get a screen set up into the middle. That's complete to Kenny Mosley. He gets it down to the Hornet 20, and that's the way the first quarter will end. Your score after one stanza. Tigers 7, Hornets 0. We'll take a break and come back for the second quarter. You're watching Hooks Hornet Football on Texarkana Game Day.
Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas!
Fans, welcome back here to Pittsburgh, reminding you once again tonight's game brought to you by Nash Electric, C&D Mechanical, Alpha Stone, the Downtowner Restaurant, and Texarkana Ag Holdings. Thank you so much for your support of Texarkana Game Day and Hooks Hornet Football. As we come into the second quarter, the Tigers have it, second down and 5 at the Hooks 20-yard line. Dangerfield leading 7-0. We'll see if this Hornet defense can stiffen up here in the red zone.
Well, and maybe even get a turnover here, a little scoop and score, pick six. Buddy, what would you think about that?
Oh, man, that would be awesome. That would be awesome.
Two receivers split to each side for Johnson. He throws to the right, incomplete. Bounces it off the turf. He was trying to connect with Amari and Simeon Jones.
Yeah, Dontrevious Coulter there on the coverage. Should that ball have gotten there?
And just speak of Dontrevious, you know, he's been out for 3 weeks. This is his first game back.
Wow.
So good to see him back.
Good to see him out there doing some things. Third down and 5 now. Chase Johnson joined in the backfield by Braden Lewis. Johnson hands it off to Lewis. Lewis trying to stretch it out. The Hornets bring him down. It looks like he may have leaned forward enough for the first down, and he did. Gets it down to the 15-yard line. It'll be just enough to move it. First down and 10 for the Tigers. So nothing too fancy there, just off tackle to the right side.
Well,
it'll be enough to move the chains.
It just seems that Dangerfield's getting an extra 1 or 2 yards after that first point of contact, and that's been the difference on a lot of these plays, especially getting past the first down marker.
Yeah, it looks like it's a stop, and then all of a sudden, yeah, like you say, just a couple of extra yards there. 3 to the left side, 1 to the right side. Handoff up the middle once again to Lewis, and he is in for the touchdown. And that time Lewis did it all by himself and just did a good job of weaving his way through some would-be tacklers. So the Tigers now up to a 2-score lead, and Hornets on offense need to answer after this one.
Yeah, Jay, the Hornet offense, the Hornet defense, I mean, are they going to have to step it up? I mean, they're going to have to get back to playing ball like they have been, and that's what it's going to take to get back in this ball game.
Hornets will be on offense when we come back from this break, 11-19. Remaining in the first half, Tigers 14, Hornets 0. We'll take a break. This is...
Here at Local Habit Coffee Company, we are true coffee connoisseurs and the area's only third-wave coffee shop. We are excited as football and fall rolls around to introduce this year's fall drink lineup. We have an all-organic homemade pumpkin spice latte, a delicious s'mores latte, and finally, a smoked maple bourbon cortado that can only be described as fall in a cup. No matter what your preference, you can get your dose of fall right here at Local Habit. We cannot wait to see you in one of our shops, and remember to go make something good happen.
All right, folks, welcome back to Pittsburgh. The Tigers score on a 14-yard touchdown run by Braden Lewis. They get a two-score lead here, 14-0 over the Hornets. Hooks waiting to receive the kick once again.
You know, Hooks has had some adversity with injuries this year. They've been behind a couple of games and been able to work through that to keep this perfect season going. You know, two touchdowns, I'm not going to say that that's a lot, but definitely want to see the defense tighten up just a little bit more, especially after that first contact.
See if we can get the offense in a rhythm here, get down and punch something in as we once again wait on a kick from Jonathan Solis. End-over-end kick will be fielded at the 16-yard line. Emmanuel Baird trying to get a return going for the Hornets. He spins off a couple of tackles, and Baird is up across the 30-yard line, up across the 40, knocked out of bounds. Near the 42, good return by Baird. He gets this crowd a little bit livened up. And Ripken, Birdwell, and company make their way back out onto the field with this Hornet offense.
Yeah, and that's the thing about Emmanuel. You know, they call him E-Man. He's been doing it all season, just like you've seen there. He even on offense, after a catch, he likes to get in there, hit a couple spins, make them miss some tackles, and bust a big play. That's what we need right here.
Absolutely, and did a good job to keep his feet chopping like you talked about and really just fighting through it, and that's good to see. Two to the right side now, one to the left side for Rip Birdwell. Hands it off to Walls. Keyshawn Walls looking for some room in the middle. Picked up about five on the play up to the 47-yard line. Brought down by number two, Quinn Webb.
Yeah, Quinn's got 127 tackles coming into tonight, with 21 of those being solo.
Hornets now, everybody in tight. Handed off to Walls again. He's going to get close to first down yardage, maybe too shy here on third down. Third down and two, gets it right to the 50-yard line.
You know, one thing that we haven't seen yet tonight is Ripken keeping the ball. And he comes in tonight with 465 yards rushing, so you sort of think that he's going to get the call sooner or later tonight.
Birdwell sends two receivers to his left side now. From the shotgun, looks to the sideline to get the play call updated. He's joined in the backfield with Walls. Keyshawn gets it going left. Lowers his shoulder and powers through the first would-be tackler. Picks up 3 yards when he needed two. It'll be enough to move the sticks. First down, Hornets. Kenny Mosley able to bring down Walls, but not until he has enough to move the sticks.
Yeah, Kenny basically was just standing up straight, and Walls able to just overpower him for that extra yard.
Birdwell has one man wide, everybody else in tight. Keyshawn Walls following all those receivers around the right side, and it's kind of the old student body right. Just pick up as many blocks as you can. That time it's good for a pickup of 8. Second down now for the Hornets. They'll scrimmage from the Dangerfield 40.
Yeah, Jaqueline Kelly's going to get credited with that tackle, but he ended up with about 4 Hornets on top of him.
Second down and 3. Birdwell wanting to throw, firing into the middle. Caught! Boogie Johnson, it's a 20, 10, 5, touchdown, Hornets! Boogie Johnson from 40 yards away.
I've got one word, pretty.
That was pretty.
Yeah, he's been doing that all season, guys. He's number 14, Boogie. He is very special.
That put a spark inside this Hornet crowd, and now we wait on the extra point.
And that is TD number 12 for Boogie Johnson.
I tell you, I was impressed with how he pulled away with some speed there, Jay, once he caught that ball.
You know, speaking of that, you know, Morgan had interviewed Coach Birdwell at, back there in 7-on-7. And he, you know, Boogie had grown so fast, you know, and so much over the summer that he was concerned with that burst speed. But you can see he's put in the work and got that back.
Absolutely. Did a good job. The extra point was no good. So it's going to be 14-6. There's 9:04 remaining in the first half. We're going to stick here with it. I want to tell you, Hornet fans and, of course, Hornet alumni, if you drive through Hooks, you drive around some of the campuses, as I've done here lately, you're going to notice a lot of improvements have happened around Hooks in the time since we've been there. Of course, it's been 1999 since I've been there, Jay, so it's a little bit longer than some of these other folks. But two wings at the elementary and the junior high have been taken down. They're about to build brand-new wings on those campuses, new learning spaces for those students are coming. They got rid of three houses right there across from the high school, a new high school gym coming that we'll be able to have basketball and volleyball in the next couple of years. New flooring at the elementary, making that look newer. Acoustical equipment in the band hall, updated that band hall, new flooring, making that a nice space for this Mighty Hornet band. The kitchen at the junior high was redone for all the meals that are going on there. And if you haven't been to the football and baseball fields, they got turf. They had the first turf baseball fields in the area. They used them a lot this last year. And then they got some new bleachers going in at the softball field. All that will be ready for baseball and softball season. So really just some impressive things going on around the district there in Hooks, and it's really good to see, especially as an alumni.
And I don't know if you mentioned it or not, Matt. I don't know if you said, but there is a new wing going in at the junior high, too.
Yes, sir. Yeah, absolutely. Both of those places. And so that's exciting to see over there for those kids and for the community there in Hooks. It's a fantastic school district, and good to see them getting some new things and the support of that community for making that happen. Manuel Baird now set to kick for the Hornets. Little Maverick-style kick, fielded at the 34-yard line by one of the up men. That's Kenny Mosley on the return for Dangerfield. He's going to get it up to the 48-yard line, and so the Tigers with a relatively short field here. And, Jay, this is a good time for this Hornet defense to stiffen up, maybe get a turnover.
Yeah, a turnover would be nice right now.
Well, I think you've got the looseness, you know, is going to be out there. You're on the scoreboard. You don't have to come down, you know, to a two-score deficit now. You know, one thing, you know, not to leave out, you got to think, is that PAT going to come back and be the difference in this game?
Yep, absolutely. Those little small things can make a difference.
They are very important.
So the Tigers huddling up. They're talking about what they want to do, and not sure what the little delay is. Oh, there's going to be a flag against Dangerfield.
Return team number 32. That 15-yard penalty being forced to the end of the run. First and 10, Dangerfield.
Going to be a personal foul during the return against the Tigers, and that's going to back them up all the way back to the 33-yard line, and so that helps this Hornet defense out a little bit. 8:57 left in the first half. Hornets now trailing it 14-6 after the Boogie Johnson touchdown. Three receivers to the left side, one receiver to the right side. Quarterback throws. Caught out by Mosley. Mosley trying to pick up some blocks around the left side. Run out of bounds by Johnson.
Yeah, Coulter just giving him a little bit more room, I guess, just out of respect. And that quick pass to the outside has been pretty successful for Dangerfield tonight.
That sets the Tigers up inside Hornet territory at the 48-yard line, first down and 10 from there. Three receivers over to the right side, one man to the left side, just a single back in the backfield with Chase Johnson. Sends the tailback to his right. Wants to throw again with a wide receiver screen. This one bounces off the turf, incomplete. Trying to set something up with Hampton. Didn't have quite enough sauce on that play. It'll be second down and 10.
Yeah, I'm not sure if I tell my defensive backs to press a little bit more, or I'm probably going to still give them the respect and just you know, try to work through some of these short across-the-field passes.
Three receivers now on the right side, one left. Handoff, tailback coming left. Hornets on it quickly. The first man back there is number 81, R.K. Minter. Good to see him back out there after a little injury scare earlier in the ball game, and he stops the ball handler immediately at the line of scrimmage. He may have got about half a yard on forward progress, but that's it.
And this is where Dangerfield has been dangerous. I don't know how many third downs they've converted, but they have been almost perfect.
Yep, big play here for this Hornet defense. The Tigers are going to send two receivers out to each side. Fake the handoff. Quarterback wants to throw. Looking left. Surveying the field. Fires. Caught. And Hampton came all the way across the formation. Birdwell was in coverage, but that's a long time to cover somebody out there. And he came all the way across the field and just found an opening.
Aaron Hampton is everything advertised, and, you know, there's a reason why he is going to the University of Texas.
Hook him.
One receiver wide to each side, everybody else in tight for Johnson and company. First and 10 at the Hornet 28. Johnson on a quarterback keeper rolling right, comes back to the left, being pursued by several white jerseys, breaks a few tackles, tiptoes down the sideline, and he's going to be shoved out of bounds near the 12-yard line, and that was a pretty impressive display of athleticism by the junior quarterback from the Tigers.
Yeah, Ripken Birdwell there to push him out of bounds, but not before he gets it inside the red zone for the Tigers.
Tigers first and 10 once again inside the Hornet 15, and so far this Hooks defense hasn't really had a lot of answers for Dangerfield. Everybody's in tight. Johnson hands the ball off to the tailback. That's Williams. He's going to be close to the end zone. Does not get in. It is enough for the first down. It'll be first and goal at the one.
Yeah, just tough running there. Very, very impressive. I think he was probably had about three Hornets that was able to keep him out, but really just blew through Ripken there.
Ashton Johnson, the ball carrier that time. First and goal now. The Hornets needing something good to happen. 7:20 remaining in the first half. Clock is rolling. Hooks trailing 14-6. And now Hooks wants to take a timeout. We're going to take a timeout with him. You're watching Hooks Hornet football on Texarkana Game Day.
You've waited long enough to achieve your dreams. At Texarkana College, now is your time to train for a new career or earn a college degree.
I got a fresh start at TC.
I didn't know where to start until TC.
It was finally my time to start at TC.
I'm finishing when I started at TC.
Texarkana College, it's your time to start or start over.
Welcome back here to Pittsburgh. The Hornets and the Tigers tied up here, first down and goal. Thanks once again to all of our sponsors for tonight's game, Nash Electric, C&D Mechanical, Alpha Stone, Downtowner Restaurant, and Texas Ag Holdings. First and goal for Dangerfield at the Hooks one. Coach Birdwell and company talking to the Hornets. I'm sure talking about assignment football. Be surprised if we don't see anything other than a run here. Tailback is Quinn Webb back in the backfield with Chase Johnson. Everybody else in tight though. Quarterback keeper Johnson dives in. He's in for the score. Touchdown. Just a lot of blue jerseys in a pile there. Johnson in from 1 yard out. Hornet offense able to go down and score on their last offensive drive. Dangerfield answers with a score of their own. Once again, Hooks will have an opportunity to tighten this thing back up.
It's blocked.
Kick is blocked. Going to be a big scrum out there on the field. So, Hornets missed an extra point. Now we got a block extra point. Kind of evens things back up there. 7:09 remaining in the first half. Tigers 20, Hornets 6. We'll take a break. You're watching Hooks Hornet Football on Texarkana Game Day. Welcome back here to Pittsburgh. There you see the Hornet cheerleaders. They're getting ready to head off to UIL competition once again in January. Last year, the first time they competed in UIL cheer. They finished 11th in the state last year at the UIL Spirit Contest, and they will head off in January to that again, and we wish them the best of luck, and they're doing a great job to keep this crowd fired up this evening.
And I know Captain Eli Bates says that he wants to do better than 11th this year.
There you go. He'd like to get there more. He is a three-time All-American. He'll be going to Charlton State next year.
That is correct.
High end-over-end kick fielded by Emmanuel Baird for the Hornets. He tries to break a few tackles and finally brought down up across the 20 near the 21-yard line. And that's where the Hornets will scrimmage. 6:59 remaining in the first half. The Tigers leading it 20-6. He's actually heading to Tarleton State tomorrow for a collegiate cheer clinic, and he wants to cheer in college. And I tell you what, I'm all for anything somebody can go get their school paid for when they graduate high school, and so proud to see them doing so well.
And I tell you, that young man, he can turn them flips through that gym. And I joke with his dad all the time. I said, did you teach him that in the backyard? And he says, heck no.
Get out there and injure yourself trying that. 6:59 for the Hornets to do something with here in the second quarter. Two receivers to the right side now, one to the left side for Ripken, Birdwell and company. Now Boogie Johnson moves across the formation over to the left slot. Ball snapped over Birdwell's head. There's a flag on the play. And that whistle.
That
coming
flag,
at a fortunate time, yes, for the Hornets.
That flag is welcomed by the Hooks Hornets.
Defense, number 3.
Ah. So they're going to get Braden Lewis for spoofing the signals there for the Hornets and maybe cause some of that, but they're going to call delay of game against him on defense. Not a penalty you see often, Jay.
No, and I think it's something that the teams do quite often, though.
Yeah. I think trying to get them mixed up, but obviously just a little bit too much on that one. So it'll be 1st and 5 now for the Hornets. And I tell you, that looked really scary. Instead, it turned into something pretty good. Ball at the 26. We're moving the chains on the other side. Ball bounces out. Birdwell back on it, and he was trying to hand it off to Walls. I don't know if Walls thought he was getting it or not, but a little bit of a bobble on the exchange between he and Birdwell, and again, the Hornets fortunate that that one did not turn over.
Yeah, number 50, Nick Wallace, was there to just happenstance to find Ripken still holding the ball there.
Yeah, I think Keyshawn was thinking he was supposed to have it. He had some displeasure after it was all said and done.
Yeah, a little bit of miscommunication out there. 2nd down now and 8 to go for Hooks. One receiver wide to each side. Birdwell gets the snap, looking left, wanting to throw. Caught, Boogie Johnson. He makes the first man miss at the 25-yard line. Lowers his shoulder at the 30. Boogie Johnson carrying several with him. and gets it up across the 30 to the 34-yard line. Jay, I thought he was stopped after about two, and instead he turns it into a first down.
Well, and he's giving Dangerfield a little bit of their own medicine, getting that first contact yardage, and really looked like a man amongst boys out there on that particular play.
First down and 10 now for the Hornets at the 34-yard line, quickly back to the line. Birdwell gets the snap, hands it off to Keyshawn Walls. Walls following some blockers around the right side, pushing and banging all the way up to the 40. Pickup of 6 yards on first down, makes it second down and 4. Stacy Lewis coming in to make the tackle. He came into tonight's game with 35 from the defensive line position. He's credited with a stop there. Hornets now stacking up 3 on the left side, 1 on the right side. Birdwell pointing out the defense and the blocking assignments for his linemen. Dropping back to throw. Birdwell firing to the right. Incomplete. Ooh. Just out of reach of Emmanuel Baird, and that's just good coverage down the field by the defender, Ilion Boyd, for the Tigers. And I'm telling you, I thought Baird had himself a touchdown, and Boyd did a good job just to get a fingertip on that ball and disrupt it just enough for it to fall incomplete. It'll be 3rd down and 4.
Yeah, Boyd actually has 2 interceptions. So anytime he can get his hands on the ball, it could be a turnover.
And he stuck that hand in there right at the right time.
Yeah, just barely got it up there. Everybody in tight for the Hornets. Keyshawn Walls coming right, trying to pick up some blocks. Has some. First down, Hornets. It's good to have something in your back pocket. Kenny Mosley coming over to make the tackle, but Walls able to follow several of those receivers. Pick up the first down, and the Hornets with a man shaking up over here on the near sideline.
Yeah, Kenny Mosley was there for the stop for Dangerfield. And looks like we are back up on our feet. That's Rod Bailey coming up a little tender for the Hornets.
And he was out there blocking in front of Keyshawn. And a lot of times in those situations, you'll see those guys get rolled up on from behind or maybe hitting the kidneys just a little bit. And have to take a minute to regain their composure. I had to regain my composure coming up these stairs here tonight.
No. Hey, them are some steep stairs.
Listen, steep stairs and a big belly in there, so that's what you get. Got me out here breathing hard for all the wrong reasons. 1st and 10, Hornets.
Not me. I went up 4 and 5 times.
Yeah. All the way at the 46-yard line. Same formation with everybody in tight. Walls now going to the left. Keyshawn Walls gets to the second level, and there's a linebacker that's going to be credited with a tackle, but I think he might give it back not to have taken that hit from Keyshawn at the end of the play.
Yeah, that was actually Hampton who ended up taking the brunt of Keyshawn there.
Pickup of 5 moves the ball just inside Dangerfield territory to the 49-yard line. Walls carrying right, has enough for the first down, and I tell you, he was just tripped up coming through the hole. He had a lot of green in front of him. Still moves the sticks down to the 41, 1st and 10, Hornets.
Yeah, Keyshawn comes up just a little tender there maybe on an ankle. So this may be a time to go to Boogie.
2 receivers split to each side. Walls moves over to the right of Rip Birdwell in the backfield. Dropping back to pass. Has a man in his face. Ripken Birdwell's going to keep it. There's a flag on the play. Birdwell picked up about 5 yards on the play. There's a flag in the area of a hold, and we'll see if that's what we get.
Holding offense, number 64.
And it is going to be a hold against the Hornets. Usually you see the white hat throwing a flag after a run play, and that's what you're going to get. That'll move Hooks back across midfield to their own 49-yard line. It'll make it 1st down and 20.
And that's unfortunate because Ripken did turn that play into some positive yards with the little scramble there.
Yeah, the first time we've seen him use his legs to get out of a jam tonight. Hooks from the right hash sends 2 receivers over to the wide side on the left. Inside slot is Boogie. Now they bring him in tight to the formation. Handoff Walls, Keyshawn Walls. Tripped up in the backfield that time. Lathan Hudson got a big paw on there and brought Keyshawn down. Got right back to the line of scrimmage. Maybe picked up one or so. And Hornets now with a man a little bit slow to get up.
Yeah, 3 minutes and 40 seconds remaining in this first half. You know, Hooks would like probably a 3 minute and 40 second drive here and take it in for a score to get it back within one score going into halftime.
The winner of this game will play the winner of the West Rusk versus New Diana game just after Thanksgiving. And that game right now, West Rusk at halftime is up 28-14 over New Diana. Also, some scores from around our area. Mansfield Summit up 7-0 over the Texas High Tigers. And Carthage is up 35-0 over Van Alstine. They're just up the road here in Mount Pleasant. It's halftime in that one, 35-0.
The player was the Hornets number 65, Grant Rampey.
Grant Rampey, the man slow to get up for the Hornets. He's able to make his way off the field on his own. So we'll see if he can get over there and get limbered up and get worked out whatever he has going on. It'll be second down now and 18 to go for the Hornets from the Dangerfield 49.
Yeah, Rampey's only a sophomore and has done a pretty good job tonight on that line for the Hornets.
Rip Birdwell and company come out in scrimmage from the 49. Three receivers out to the left side, one to the right side. Keyshawn Walls, the lone back. Birdwell wants to throw, and he is hit from the side. The Tigers brought pressure around the left end. Braden Lewis was on top of Birdwell before he even got out of his steps, and I'm not even sure he could see him coming.
Yeah, Birdwell was just lucky enough just to hang on to the ball because Dangerfield got there quick and drove him into the ground, bringing up a third and a lot.
Third and long for the Hornets. You feel like you can probably be in two-down territory here. Maybe pick up a couple of chunks at a time. Birdwell wants to throw. Now he's going to have to pull it down. Doesn't have anywhere to go. Ripken Birdwell gets the yardage back from the last play to the Dangerfield 49. Had some room in front of him. Jaquillen Kelly tracks him down from behind. Dangerfield calls a timeout. They want to stop the clock with 2:39 left. And so they try to preserve some time before they go to halftime. We will bring you both band performances during halftime. Do want to let you know in the playoffs, each band plays to their home side. So you'll see Dangerfield facing the opposite side away from us, and then Hooks will face the home side over here. The winner of this game plays the winner of the West Rusk New Diana game. And again, West Rusk is up 28-14 over New Diana. You feel like that game will be the day after Thanksgiving. Up in 4A, Pleasant Grove and Carthage, it looks like. Carthage up 35-0. We'll play each other the day after Thanksgiving, 2 o'clock p.m. at Pine Tree High School. We will have the call for you on NFHS Network with the Texarkana Game Day crew. And so you can either join us there in Longview, or if you still got lots of people at your house, you can watch on NFHS. Or you can tell them to leave, Jay, so you can come down and watch the game.
That's right.
And it'd be really nice if this Hornet team can pull out a win tonight. Maybe we can set up a doubleheader and get West Rusk and them to play there as well. I'd like to see
7
it.
O'clock.
Yeah, wouldn't that be cool? Game? Yeah, 2 o'clock, 7 o'clock.
I'd be there.
We'd all be there. Fourth now and 18 for the Hornets, and so Birdwell will kick high, end over end kick. And it's going to bounce at the 20 and take a good Hooks roll. It's going to go all the way down to the 1 yard line.
That was Jasper Crane on that punt.
Oh, I'm sorry. Those numbers kind of mix up. Thanks for keeping me out of trouble.
The 8 and the zeros.
So Crane gets it. So 226. Dangerfield will have to go 99 yards. And 225. We'll see maybe now if we see this Hornet defense pin their ears back a little bit, Jay, and try to make something happen on the defensive side of the ball.
Yeah, a little pressure here. Could make this game interesting. A little safety and then get the ball back.
Each team with one timeout remaining. Just under 2.5 minutes here. Yeah, it'd be nice to get a safety or a pick six.
A very important play is about to happen.
Chase Johnson from his own end zone in the shotgun with a receiver to each side. Drops back and wants to throw. He's going to pull it down now and run for it. Gets it out just inside the 10. Several Hornets converge on him there, and Johnson does a good job just to get out of the shadow of his own end zone. Picks up about 7 yards on first down. It'll be second down and 3 up at the 8-yard line.
Well, and the Hornets do a good job standing him up. I would like to see a little ripping of the arms, maybe try to force a fumble by these Hooks Hornets.
Second down now for Dangerfield. Two receivers to each side. They hand off to the tailback, Braden Lewis, and he is brought down in the backfield. The Hornets coming up from behind to pull down the ball carrier.
Number three.
Another big third down here.
On the carry. And on the tackle, number 81, Kadrian Benner. No gain on the play.
So R.K. Mentor making the tackle there.
Third down and three.
It'll be third and three. Now Dangerfield letting some time roll off the play clock. And you say they've converted all their third downs. This will be a good time to stop them on that. Hand off to the tailback again. He's going to have just enough for the first down. Boogie making the tackle until he gets up across the 15-yard line to the 18-yard line. That's Braden Lewis once again on the carry. And that'll move the sticks. First down and 10 from the 18. Now the Tigers using a little bit of tempo. Two receivers stacked up close to the line on the left. Quarterback wants to throw. Caught out on the left side by Kenny Mosley. He makes a good move. Gets into the second level up to the 35-yard line. Clock will stop temporarily at 43 seconds while they reset the chains. First and 10, Dangerfield.
Yeah, 13, Logan Baker there on the stop for Hooks.
Three receivers to the right side, one receiver to the left side for Chase Johnson. Drops back in shotgun, wants to throw, surveying the field, has some time, fires into the middle. Ball's tipped, and it's picked. Hornets have it. And the Hooks defense forces a turnover.
Yeah, Logan Baker there after the tip drill, able to come up with that interception, and that is his third interception of the season.
That is very big and a big swing for the Hornets.
Good time to make a stop there. 20 seconds left in the first half to at least stop a potential scoring drive there, and we'll see if the Hornets have time for maybe a play or two. Hooks does have one timeout. 20 seconds. I need to go 47 yards.
What is big here is that offensive line has to give Burwell time to throw.
Absolutely. Yeah, and he's had some time at times, and then other times
more often than not.
Had some guys in the backfield. Hooks will come out with an empty backfield. Keyshawn Walls. Out to the left. Nope, now he comes back over and switches sides. We're moving around out here. All right, now we got them stacked up. Three receivers on the left side, nobody right side, and now Dangerfield is going to call a timeout. They got a little bit concerned about the alignment that the Hornets were putting out there.
Well, I was going to say Grant Rampey is still on the sideline, so there's at least one offensive lineman that may need to get a little help from his fellow lineman on making sure he gets his blocking assignment right so Ripken can stay upright and try to put the ball into Boogie's hands.
And so you see the Hornets had three receivers stacked up to the left side. Keyshawn Walls, one of those receivers in that formation. And then, like you say, Boogie Johnson over on the right side by himself. To me, that either sets up a screen pass to the left with Keyshawn or a one-on-one opportunity over on the right side with Boogie. Either of those, you feel like maybe the Hornets would have a chance to do something with. And so Dangerfield wanted to call a timeout and talk about it there. The Hornet Band will be on the field at halftime. This year they finished in the top 10 of the area finals, finishing number 9, the highest finish in school history, and only the second time in 24 years to make the area finals. And so the Hooks Hornet Band with a very successful marching season, and we'll get to join them out on the field at halftime. So make sure you stick around to watch that. Birdwell and Company now back with two receivers to each side. Throws it underneath. Caught by Rod Bailey. Bailey on the move. Gets it inside Dangerfield territory. The clock will stop temporarily at 14 seconds while we reset the chains. He's down to the 41. And the Hornets call a timeout.
Hey, Matt, but speaking about that, was it ninth place in the area? For
yeah,
the band?
Ninth place in the area.
Another funny story about Eli Bates' dad. He was at the competition, and when they announced the ninth place finish, everybody went crazy. And he was like, what's going on? And so he walks down the field, and he talks to Mr. Kelly, and he's like, Mr. Kelly's like, you just don't realize ninth place is a right. big accomplishment.
Absolutely.
You know, and he's used to, like, one, two, or three.
Yeah.
You know, so it was real funny hearing Bates tell that story. But, yeah, our band and Mr. Kelly and the other band directors, man, they do a great job.
Absolutely. Very impressive things they're doing. And the 3A band up here in this region is very good. As a matter of fact, the top bands in the state all came from up here when they went down to San Antonio. And so super proud of that Hornet Band. I myself a product of the mighty Hornet Band drumline back in the day. After the timeout now, the Hornets bring it out. Three receivers to the left side, one to the right side for Ripken, Birdwell, and Company. We scrimmage from the 41-yard line. Birdwell in an empty backfield, running away from pressure, fires incomplete. Trying to get it to Jorge Velasquez. Clock stopped at 8 seconds, and Birdwell doing a good job to get rid of that ball. Number 12, Jaquillen Kelly, providing some pressure there against the junior quarterback. Or sophomore quarterback, right? No.
Yeah, I definitely haven't watched Hooks enough to see if they have many rollout passes, but that may be something that they want to go ahead and call because there's definitely some pressure coming through the middle for Dangerfield.
They have to try to get around.
That's going to be one of the things that Coach Ledford and they're going to talk about that at halftime.
Two receivers to the left side, one to the right side.
Delay of game.
And there'll be a delay of game. Against the Hornets. They're trying to get everything set up. And there's a little bit of confusion out there. Back them up 5 yards. I don't know if that matters as much as the time. Really, probably time for one more play here unless you get out of bounds in a hurry. 8 seconds on the clock here in the second quarter. Two receivers left side, one receiver right side. Walls back in at tailback. Birdwell gets the snap. Makes the first man miss, firing down the field. Incomplete, and there's some flags that are going to come in. Emmanuel Baird had several guys on him.
Pass is picked off, but we do have a penalty flag on the field.
Number 60, Tamarian Smith, just introduced himself to Kenny Mosley there, and it was not pretty.
That did not finish well.
No, Mosley had, I think what he thought was an interception. Saw a lot of the flags there on pass interference. And, yeah, Tamarian Smith came up and put a shot on him. So the time is off of the game clock. However, there will be one more play.
So that's going to get it inside or right at the 30.
So There will be one untimed down here from the 31-yard line. Hornets with a chance here for something to get to the end zone. Three receivers to the right side. One receiver to the left side. Birdwell dropping back. The line holds. Firing down the field. Tipped in the air. Incomplete. And that's how we'll go into halftime. Your score at the half. Tigers 20. Hornets 6. Jay, we'll see what sort of adjustments each team makes. Hornet defense forces a turnover here at the end of the first half. Gives the offense a chance at life, just unable to connect on that last pass there. Hornet offense will need to come out and get moving. We will bring you the band performances here in just a moment. First, we're going to take a break, let you hear from some of our sponsors, and then we'll be back for halftime here in Pittsburgh. You're watching Hooks Hornet football on Texarkana Game Day.
We are excited to announce here at Texarkana Emergency Center and Hospital that we have expanded our capabilities to better serve our community. As a hospital, we have the capability for inpatient services. After your outstanding emergency care, we can smoothly transition you into one of our new inpatient rooms that have telemetry monitors in every room to continue your concierge medicine care. While our patients continue receiving their care in their inpatient suites, we also make sure that your loved ones are taken care of with our outstanding facilities. Our added services include a procedure room and also the capability of MRIs. With our imaging, we are able to offer outpatient, inpatient, and emergency room MRI, CT, ultrasound, and X-ray. We are honored by your support and look forward to serving all your future medical needs.
Nikki Curtis with Curtis Performing Arts in Few Springs. The 2023 members are Senior, Reseda Garcia. Sophomore, Kaslyn McKnight. Senior, Brenna Haskins. Freshman, Janiyah Steele. Junior, Lieutenant, Sarah Hughes. Junior, Tay Brown. Junior, and Captain, J.C. Satterfield. Junior, Desiah McCoy. Junior and Major, Kylan Tyler. Freshman, Rebecca Swindle. Junior, Lieutenant, Lizzie Cruz. Sophomore, Jasmine Satterfield. And sophomore, Rakaya Fields. The Bells will now perform a routine to Jump in the Line.
Sonora. I tell you, friends, I adore her. And when she dances, oh brother, she's a hurricane in all kinds of weather. Jump in the line, rock your body and time. Okay, I believe you. Jump in the line, rock your body and time. Okay, I believe you. Jump in the line, rock your body and time. Okay, I believe you. Jump in the line, rock your body and time. Shake, 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 Sonora, shake your body line. Whoop. Shake, 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 Sonora, shake it all the time. Work, 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 Sonora, work your body line. Work, 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 Sonora, work it all the time. You can talk about cha-cha, tango, waltz, or the rumba. Sonora's dance has no title. You jump in the saddle, hold on to the bridle. Jump in the line, rock your body and time. Okay, I believe you. Jump in the line, rock your body. Rock your body, child. Jump in the line, rock your body in time. Somebody help me. Jump in the line, rock your body in time. Whoop. Shake, 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 Sonora, shake your body line. Shake, 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 Sonora, shake it all the time. Whoop. Work, 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 Sonora, work your body line. Yeah. Work, 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 Sonora, work it all the time.
Ladies and gentlemen, taking the field for your halftime entertainment, it is my pleasure to introduce the world's best band from Tigerland, the 2023 Dangerfield Band. Band is directed by Bobby Alford and assisted by Kelton Ashcraft, Ryan Brandish, and Jax Newman. Band is under the field direction of head drum major Mia Broughton and assistant drum major Caitlin Key. Drum captain is Dante Salazar. Color guard captain is Emily Beasley. Band student of the week is Tessa Pollen, and the color guard student of the week is Taylor Lowry. Tonight, the band will perform Ray Charles' Georgia on My Mind, Bruno Mars's Locked Out of Heaven, in addition to the Dangerfield fight song Eye of the Tiger.
Same dirt.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen,
From the second half of your halftime entertainment, Hooks High School is proud to present, under the field command of senior drum major Slayton Batts, presenting their 2023 show, Fire and Ice, the Hooks High School Marching Band. Hooks High School Marching Band. The band is under the direction of T. John Kelly, Belen Graves, and Megan Samaniego. Color guard instructor is Burgundy Krause, tech coordinator is Nick Graves, and student intern is Caleb Castle. Soloists for tonight's performance were Landon Bloxham and Eli Bates. Section of the week is the flute section. The rookie of the week is Audrey Roach, and the student of the week is Jeffrey Cunningham. We'd like to thank our Platinum Plus sponsors, First Baptist Church Hooks, Robert Morris Racing, Wisdom Animal Clinic, Unique Travels and Tours, CC's Pizza, Legacy Rentals and Sales, Let's Go Builders, Daphne de Santiago, ATK Outdoor Solutions, Myrtle Springs Baptist Church, Texarkana Harley Davidson, Scooters Pizza, Texar, and Anubis Treasures and Collectibles. The next performance of the band will either be next week in the third round of the playoffs or December 14th in their annual Christmas concert. Until then, thank you for your attention, and we'll see you soon.
We are excited to announce here at Texarkana Emergency Center and Hospital that we have expanded our capabilities to better serve our community. As a hospital, we have the capability for inpatient services. After your outstanding emergency care, we can smoothly transition you into one of our new inpatient rooms that have telemetry monitors in every room to continue your concierge medicine care. While our patients continue receiving their care in their inpatient suites, we also make sure that your loved ones are taken care of with our outstanding facilities. Our added services include a procedure room and also the capability of MRIs. With our imaging, we are able to offer outpatient, inpatient, and emergency room MRI, CT, ultrasound, and X-ray. We are honored by your support and look forward to serving all your future medical needs.
Life is busy, and we get it. The State Bank mobile app was designed to make banking more convenient for you.
Check account activity, make transfers, pay bills, and manage your debit card in a snap. You can deposit checks from the convenience of your home or wherever life lands you.
The State Bank app lets you organize your accounts, manage alerts, and easily email our customer service experts.
Now that you have State Bank at your fingertips, you can spend more time doing what's important to you.
Your family, your bank, State Bank.
Here at Local Habit Coffee Company, we are true coffee connoisseurs and the area's only third wave coffee shop. We are excited as football and fall rolls around to introduce this year's fall drink lineup. We have an all organic homemade pumpkin spice latte, a delicious s'mores latte, and finally, a smoked maple bourbon cortado that can only be described as fall in a cup. No matter what your preference, you can get your dose of fall right here at Local Habit. We cannot wait to see you in one of our shops. And remember to go make something good happen.
You've waited long enough to achieve your dreams. At Texarkana College, now is your time to train for a new career or earn a college degree.
I got a fresh start at TC.
I didn't know where to start until TC.
It was finally my time to start at TC.
I'm finishing what I started at TC.
Texarkana College, it's your time to start or start over.
Tonight's area matchup between the Hooks Hornets and the Dangerfield Tigers is brought to you by Nash Electric and Mr. Chris Harris over there, C&D Mechanical, Alpha Stone, the Downtowner Restaurant, and Texarkana Ag Holdings. Would not be able to bring this game to you without all of their support, and we want to let them know how much we appreciate it. We'll give you some scores from around the area as well on this week two of the playoffs. Of course, New Boston and Newton played last night. Newton getting the best of that one, 69-7. Gilmer squeezed one out against Sunnyvale, 41-38. That game was also last night. The Cooper Bulldogs are up 63-14 over the Shelbyville Dragons. New Diana and Rusk, the winner of tonight's game, faces the winner of this game next week. West Rusk is up 36-21 over New Diana. Now the Carthage game says 42-0. There we go, 42-0 over Van Alstine. Just changed here. Timpson is up 41-7 over Wolf City. Honeygrove up 27-21 over Centerville. Harmony, also in this region in 3A, 34-6 over ARP. Malakoff is up 38-14 over Mount Vernon. And Mansfield Summit leads Texarkana Texas High 14-7. So the games get tighter, Jay. You look at the big bracket of all the teams involved in the playoffs, and you look at every name on there, only one of those gets to end the season with
and
a win.
Welcome back for the second half of play, the 2023 Hooks.
Everybody else gets ready to start.
Well, the question's going to be what type of halftime adjustments that Coach Birdwell and his staff have put together for this defense to be able to hold Dangerfield a couple of possessions to try to get this to a tie game or at least within one score to make this a game in the fourth quarter. And, you know, I think you just coach them, hey, let's just take care of this first series and see what we can do and try to get some points on the board. You know, two scores for this Hooks offense,
yep.
It's not too much to ask. We just need the defense to step up and get the ball back and allow Ripken to be able to do what he does.
So the story of the first half, three scores from Dangerfield. The first one, a pass to Braden Lewis. The second one, a Braden Lewis 14-yard touchdown run. And the third one, Chase Johnson, quarterback, one-yard dive in for the Hornets. A 40-yard touchdown pass from Ripken Birdwell to Jatavius Boogie Johnson. The score for the Hornets, and that's how we got to 20-6. Each team missing one extra point opportunity. The Hornets will kick off to start the second half. They received the ball to start this ball game. So Emmanuel Baird has it teed up, set to kick. Is marching it off from right in the middle of the 40-yard line. As we get ready for the second half to get underway here in Pittsburgh. Little squib kick down the field. And the man on the recovery for the Tigers downs it right at the 35-yard line. That's where Dangerfield will take over first and 10. And so, Jay, here it is. This first drive, I think, is going to set the tone for what each team wants to do as we go through the final two quarters here.
Well, and whether it's a big hit or a big breakup or possibly even a turnover, just something to be able to get this defense a little confidence against this Chase Johnson Tiger offense.
Yeah, and, of course, the defense did get a turnover there at the end of the first half. We'll see if they can keep that going. Looks like now the slot receiver over here on the left side for the Tigers got moving a little bit early, so they're going to back them up to the 30-yard line. And it'll be first down and 15 to go. Nobody has left yet, though. Every seat, and I don't know what the capacity of Pittsburgh High School Stadium is, but we are right at it, if not all the way at it tonight. And just a good crowd, raucous group of folks out here this evening. Little handoff up the middle from Lewis. Might have picked up 3 yards on the play before Birdwell came up and stuck him. It'll be second down and 12 to go. So Birdwell coming up to make a quick stop. Three receivers left side, one receiver right side now. Chase Johnson, the quarterback for the Tigers. Hornets showing pressure from the right side. Now they get a man in the middle. Johnson going to pull it down, though. Picks up a good block down the field, and Chase Johnson still on his feet across midfield. Brought down inside Hornet territory. Down at the 45-yard line, Logan Baker comes up to make the tackle. And the Hornets gambled on that one, sent some pressure, and Johnson did a good job of squeezing out of the backfield and getting into Hornet territory.
Yeah, Williams was downfield expecting a pass and made a very good block about the 50-yard line to get him another 5 yards.
Tigers with one receiver wide to each side. Hand the ball off this time to Ashton Williams. He comes left. He's going to be brought down by Ashton Odom of the Hornets. It'll be a 5-yard pickup. Down to the hooks, 40. Second down and 5 to go from there.
Yeah, Hooks really needs a couple of negative plays here in a row to force possibly a punt so that they could get the ball back here.
They got a receiver wide to each side. Two receivers stacked up right near the line on the right side. Quarterback keeper the whole way here as Johnson picks up a couple of blocks around the left side. He'll be knocked out of bounds by Jasper Crane, but he gets just enough for the first down.
Result of the play is a first down.
It'll move the sticks, first and 10. Dangerfield. See Coach Birdwell, the defensive coordinator, out there giving signals to his defense. One receiver wide to each side, still in the same formation. Johnson rolling right, wants to throw. Now he pulls it down. Has some room in the middle. Birdwell, the linebacker who's the spy on the quarterback, gets a hand on his waist, gets a little bit of help. It'll be enough for the first down. He kept it from being even more. Crane coming in to help clean that one up.
Yeah, still seeing a little bit of the same that we saw from the Tigers in the first half, and just not seeing any answers yet by this Hooks defense.
Snap back, hand off Williams. Ashton Williams.
Ashton Williams, number one on the carry.
Runs into big number 73, Aiden Ashmore. Be a pickup of 4 yards on the play. And I tell you, Williams, when he got to the line, had a full head of steam behind himself.
Yeah, he actually pushed Ashmore back about 3 yards for that 4-yard gain.
Makes it second down and 6 now as they spread the receivers out two to each side. Williams again into the middle. Gets up to the second level. Boogie Johnson makes the tackle from the safety position, but it'll be enough to move the sticks down to the 12. So Dangerfield able to get something going here, and they're inside the Hornet red zone once again as we roll inside of 9 minutes remaining in the third. Johnson. Little keeper around the right side follows his tailback, Williams. It was a read option play, and Johnson just kept it. Ashton Williams doing a good job of blocks down the field all the way down to the one. It's first and goal once again for Dangerfield.
Yeah, a good spin move to get that extra 3 or 4 yards on that run there. Dangerfield all gazing to the sideline for the play call.
And Clock will be inside 8.5 minutes in the third quarter on the snap. Move blockers over to the left side. Quarterback keeper, he's going to follow him from there, and he's in. Touchdown, Dangerfield. So the Tigers picking up where they left off in the first half, able to march it down the field. And, Jay, like you said, so far the Hornet defense just hasn't had an answer for this Tiger offense.
Yeah, the offensive line for the Tigers has basically just, you know, done what they wanted to tonight and just opened up some real good holes. And something's just going to have to give, either change that front or maybe just bring the linebackers in a step closer.
After the missed extra point earlier, Dangerfield going to go for two on this one. Again, everybody heavy to the left. The ball bounces around on the field. The Hornets will have it, and so this two-point conversion will fail. Would have been nice for that to happen to play ahead of time for the Hornets instead of on the conversion. However, 8:15 in the third. Hooks now trailing 26-6. We'll take a break. You're watching Hooks Hornet Football on Texarkana Game Day.
Here at Local Habit Coffee Company, we are true coffee connoisseurs and the area's only third-wave coffee shop. We are excited as football and fall rolls around to introduce this year's fall drink lineup. We have an all-organic homemade pumpkin spice latte, a delicious s'mores latte, and finally, a smoked maple bourbon cortado that can only be described as fall in a cup. No matter what your preference, you can get your dose of fall right here at Local Habit. We cannot wait to see you in one of our shops, and remember to go make something good happen. Here at Local.
All right, welcome back here to Pittsburgh. And, Jay, you see you were able to look up and see how many this stadium holds here in Pittsburgh.
Yeah, TexasBob.com is a good website that I go to for all of the stadiums here in Texas. And this Pirate Stadium has the capacity of 5,112 people.
I guess we probably got at least 5,000 then here.
There's some folks standing, so yes, we're definitely more than 5,000 people here tonight.
Dangerfield set to kick off once again, Jonathan Solis. High end over end kick, fill it at the 22-yard line by the deep man Baird for the Hornets. And he's going to get up to the 40. First and 10 Hooks from there. As we go, do want to take a moment and thank all of our sponsors. Of course, Nash Electric helping us this evening. Alpha Stone of Texarkana. C&D Mechanical. The Downtowner Restaurant. And Texarkana Ag Holdings, LLC. Thank you guys so much for your sponsorship tonight. Hornets now back on offense for the first time in the third quarter. Scrimmaging from the 40. Now Johnson moves in motion to the left. They give to him. No, fake to him. Little gut draw up the middle with Keyshawn Walls. And so trying a little bit of misdirection. Walls gets 3 yards on the play. Big number 72, Jared Holloman, Stacy Lewis on the tackle. It's a different number. Oh, I'm looking on the JV roster. What am I doing? Walls once again. Birdwell on the keeper. As they fake to Walls. There's a flag on the play. I'm not sure what.
Yeah, Kenny Mosley was there on the stop and stood Ripken up straight up, and a couple of Tigers joined him to keep him just short of the first down marker.
Well, I don't know what the referee was saying. I thought there was a penalty, but obviously not. Third down and two now. Fake to Walls. Birdwell rolling left. Caught out of the backfield by Baird, and Baird had some room if he turned around and ran with the ball right when he got it. Kind of took some time to maybe gather his feet under himself. And it's going to be fourth down and about a yard for the Hornets right here at midfield.
Yeah, Trent Boyd was able to come off of his block and just keep him from being able to get a first down.
Hook spreads them out, two to the right, one to the left. Birdwell looks over to the coaches, 10 seconds on the play clock. He moves Walls to his left. There's going to be a flag. Got bouncing around. So, again, a little bit of confusion with the calls coming from the sideline, and a fourth and one becomes a fourth and six, and that's a lot taller order there, Jay.
Well, and you know, there's got to be just a little bit of frustration coming from the team right now. You know, when you start making mistakes like this down three scores, and you start thinking how much time is left in the game. So, positive thing is going to have to occur for Hooks here pretty soon, just so that they can get this momentum turned around.
It'll be a good time for that positive action. Fourth down and six for this Hooks offense. Two receivers to the right side, one to the left side. Baird, the tight end, on the right side. Birdwell wants to throw. It's caught by Baird underneath. He breaks the tackle and has the first down. Baird inside the 40 down to the 39, and I thought he was dead to rights, about a yard shy. And he was able to break free of a tackle and get down for the first down all the way down to the 38-yard line.
Yeah, Marion Simmons-Jones there, I believe, saved a touchdown.
Yeah, Baird had a full head of steam there as he broke free. Two to the left side now, one to the right side for Birdwell from the right hash. Hornets at the 38. Birdwell wants to throw, looking into the middle. Now he's going to pull it down. Has some green grass in front of him. Birdwell has enough for the first down. Lowers his shoulder and punches into the defender at the 25. Trent Boyd making the tackle, but not until Ripken Birdwell picks up the first with his feet down to the 25-yard line.
Yeah, Quinn Webb was also there and actually took the brunt of Ripken and a little slow to get up.
First and 10 now for the Hornets. Three receivers stacked on top of each other right on the right side of the line. Keyshawn Walls following them around the right. Keeps his feet driving. It'll be a short gain for Walls on first down. Maybe three. Kenny Mosley comes up once again from the defensive back position to make the tackle. Mosley has had several stops this evening. It'll be second down and eight now for the Hornets. Single receiver out wide. Everybody else in tight. Birdwell pulls it out of the stomach.
Number 11, Ripken Birdwell on the
Ripken will be maybe a yard shy of the first down as he ran around the right side. Faked the handoff to Walls. Pulled it out of the gut.
Brings up a third down and one.
Got it down to the 16.
Yeah, Texas commit Hampton comes up from that safety spot and forces Ripken to leap just short of the first down marker.
Jorge Velasquez, the lone receiver, wide out to the left. Keyshawn Walls carries around the right side, bounces off the first tackler. Has enough for the first down, down to the 11. First and 10, Hornets from there.
Yeah, Kenny Mosley once again there to put a good hit, but just not wrapping up to allow Keyshawn to move those chains. Not quite first and goal, but they are in the shadow of the goalpost.
Hornets scrimmage from the 11. Move a man in motion. Everybody's on the right side. Keyshawn Walls goes to the left. Tigers read it well. They kept a spy over on the left side. Number 11, Ileon Boyd, forced Walls to go back inside. Jaqueline Kelly was able to bring him down, but that play was designed, Jay, for Walls to be able to bounce it outside, and Boyd did a good job to stay home and force it back in to get some help.
Well, and just a real good move to stay on that outside shoulder on the far offensive lineman to be able to force that back in for practically a loss of one.
Loss of one makes it second down and 11. Birdwell wants to throw. Fires right. Caught Boogie Johnson inside the 10. Flipped up and around the 7.
Number 14, Jatavius Johnson. Defending on the play, number 6, Marion Simmons-Jones.
Marion Simmons-Jones comes up to make the stop.
Brings up a third down and 8.
Yeah, Dangerfield doing a real good job keeping receivers in front and not allowing them to get much yardage when they do catch, but just, you know, putting good hits on those players.
Third down and eight now for the Hornets. Birdwell wants to throw again, looking left. Now looks back right, has a lot of guys in his face, firing toward the end zone, and it floats out of bounds, incomplete. Birdwell's momentum carrying him to the right side, sent the ball out where it was uncatchable.
Yeah, Jaqueline Kelly there just putting the pressure, causing Ripken to have to throw that out of bounds. Big fourth down play.
Fourth down and eight now for the Hornets. Inside of 2 minutes here in the third quarter. Third quarter has gone quickly. You don't want to say it's a do-or-die situation for Hooks, but you get down this close, you've got to get some points on the board. And they're going to take a timeout. They want to talk about it. We're going to take a timeout with them. Timeout here on the field. You're watching Hooks Hornet football on Texarkana game day. This is Texas A&M timeout. Coming out of the timeout, timeout's brought to you by Texas A&M, Texarkana, Jay A&M. Getting ready for an expansion of sports out there. A new baseball and softball dig coming. And
eSports.
Man, looks like a nice facility coming on. And then, yeah, eSports, one of the fastest growing areas in both high school and in college. Computerized gaming and the like. And really one of those things that allows a lot of kids to get involved. And so, exciting things happening at A&M Texarkana. Out of the timeout, the Hornets, goodness gracious, have fourth down and eight. Two receivers to the right side, one receiver to the left side. Birdwell wants to throw. Hit immediately. Breaks free of the tackler's throw. Fires. Intercepted. The Tigers have it. Kenny Mosley comes across the formation. There's a flag that comes in late. Birdwell did a good job to keep that play alive. He was hit by several Tigers in the backfield. Threw it in the end zone. Mosley was able to step in front of the intended receiver. He brings it out to the 25-yard line. We'll sort out the flags.
Yeah, Kenny Mosley has just had a phenomenal night. Just tends to be in the right place at the right time.
Yeah, we've called his name several times, being involved in tackles, and that time gets the first turnover of the evening for Dangerfield.
It's an interception. After the play was over, dead ball, unsportsmanlike conduct against the intercepting team's number eight. That penalty will be enforced half the distance to the goal from the end of the play. Will be first down and 10, Dangerfield. That is number eight, first.
So an unsportsmanlike penalty against Arian Hampton. The interception will stand. The 15-yard penalty will back the Tigers up to the 10. And, Jay, 1:52 in the third, trailing by 20. The Hornets need to get a stop, and they need to get it quickly.
Yeah, the defense has to make a stop on this series before this game definitely gets out of hand. And you just got to ask yourself which Hornet's going to step up and make this big play to sort of get this momentum turned around.
Exactly right. One play can cut into this lead significantly. So first and 10 for the Tigers from the 10 is Chase Johnson and company. Come out with everybody in tight. Everybody's within about 5 yards of the ball. And the ball off to Lewis. He has scored twice tonight. He gets up across the 15-yard line to the 16. It'll be second down and four. Aiden Ashmore making the tackle for the Hornets.
Yeah, Williams is just being able to take Ashmore back a few yards every time that they meet at the line of scrimmage.
Two receivers to each side. Williams again on the carry. Rifkin Birdwell able to bring him down, but not until he has enough for the first down. Gets it up to the 23-yard line. And, Jay, we've talked about it a few times, but it seems like Tigers are getting about 2 yards after contact on most plays, and it's really just enough to help them move the sticks on several of these plays.
Yeah, and unfortunately, their RK and Rifkin Birdwell ran into each other on that play, and Rifkin has come off onto the sideline and sitting down at the bench right now. Hopefully he'll be able to come back in a play or two.
Three receivers left, one right. Williams coming around the left side. Breaks the first tackle, gets up across the 30. There's a flag on the play. Williams gets it across midfield, shoved out of bounds inside Hook's territory at the 46-yard line. There's a play all the way back at the 32. All indications are it's going to be against the Tigers. Holding at the point of attack. That call against Arian Hampton. That'll move him back 10 yards from there. The Dangerfield fans do not approve of that call.
Penalty was against Dangerfield. Holding was the call.
37 seconds remain in the third quarter.
And the bad thing about that penalty is basically all that did was take time off the clock.
Make it first down and 11 after the penalty. Chase Johnson will have one receiver wide to each side. He drops back wanting to throw. Firing down the middle of the field. Has a man there, and it is caught.
There's a reason why the University of Texas has shown some interest in Mr. Hampton.
Arian Hampton just got behind both defenders. He kind of slipped as he stopped to catch that ball. Otherwise, he may still be running. He falls down at the Hornet 33. It'll be first and 10 from there, and that's the way the third quarter is going to end. Your score after three, Tigers 26, Hornets 6. We'll take a break and come back for the fourth quarter. You're watching Hooks Hornet football on Texarkana Game Day.
We are excited to announce here at Texarkana Emergency Center and Hospital that we have expanded our capabilities to better serve our community. As a hospital, we have the capability for inpatient services. After your outstanding emergency care, we can smoothly transition you into one of our new inpatient rooms that have telemetry monitors in every room to continue your concierge medicine care. While our patients continue receiving their care in their inpatient suites, we also make sure that your loved ones are taken care of with our outstanding facilities. Our added services include a procedure room and also the capability of MRIs. With our imaging, we are able to offer outpatient, inpatient, and emergency room MRI, CT, ultrasound, and X-ray. We are honored by your support and look forward to serving all your future medical needs.
All right, welcome back here to Pittsburgh as we get ready to start the fourth quarter. We have switched ends of the field. First and 10 Tigers at the Hornet 33-yard line. Three receivers on the left side, one receiver on the right side for Chase Johnson. He hands the ball off to Braden Lewis. Lewis comes around the left side. He'll be knocked out of bounds inside the Hornet 15 at the 14. Logan Baker on the stop.
Logan Baker, number 13 on the
Yeah, Lewis there just tight-roping there at the end. Baker able to force him out of bounds, but not before he is inside the red zone once again for these Tigers. Dangerfield, no hurry to get to the ball.
Johnson hands the ball to Lewis again. Lewis, off tackle to the left. Hornets come up, make the stop after a short gain. That's Ripken Birdwell who comes up to make the tackle.
Down by Ripken Birdwell, number 11, gain of one on the play. Second down and nine.
Hornets with 94 points last week, 6 points tonight, and a big difference in two games there. And we talked about it there off the air just a little bit, Jay. So many just super close plays, either on defense and offense. Just so far, none of those have fallen the Hornets' way this evening. Chase Johnson on quarterback keeper coming around the left side now. He's going to have enough for the first down and actually breaks the tackle and gets in for the touchdown from 14 yards away. Chase Johnson, that's his second touchdown run of the evening.
Yeah, Chase just very, very talented. He's been very, very impressive tonight to me. First time I've been able to watch him outside of just some highlights.
So they get in and score, and it's just one of those games, and you've been a part of them sometimes, Jay, where it just seems like everything bounces in one team's favor. Maybe if these teams play 10 times, you have a split or something close. But so far tonight, all of those little things, little bounces one way or the other, have gone to Dangerfield. That time, once again, a score from Chase Johnson. There's 11 minutes and 4 seconds left in the ball game. Tigers 33, Hornets 6. We'll take a break. You're watching Hooks Hornet Football on Texarkana Game Day.
Whether you're looking for a new or pre-owned car, truck, or SUV, or maybe a new or pre-owned boat or RV, care for a car wash, had a fender bender, or you need service on your vehicle, boat, or RV, we have it all when you let us exceed your expectations at Greg Orr Auto Marine and RV in Shreveport, Texarkana, and Ashdown. Shop hassle-free and always be treated like family while choosing from our sensational selection. In Shreveport, visit Orr Acura, Orr BMW, Orr Cadillac, Orr Infiniti, and the Greg Orr Pre-Owned Supercenter. In Texarkana, Mercedes-Benz of Texarkana, Classic Buick GMC, Classic Cadillac, Classic Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram, Classic Kia, Classic Mazda, Classic Pre-Owned, The Classic Car Wash, Greg Orr Marine and RV, Greg Orr Collision, and Classic Chevrolet in Ashdown. Or visit gregorrauto.com.
Welcome back here to Pittsburgh. 11:04 remaining in the ballgame. Dangerfield leading over Hook, 33-6. And the Tigers once again set to kick off. Jonathan Solis with the kicking duties after a 14-yard Chase Johnson touchdown run. Expands the Tiger lead. High kick, bounces at the 15-yard line, scooped up by the return man for the Hornets there. He's going to be hit after he steps out of bounds. They're going to add 15 yards to this. He stepped out near the 18-yard line. So we're going to add 15 to the end of this. It'll take it up near the 33-yard line, and that's where the Hornets will have it first down and 10.
Well, Ripken Birdwell is going to come out once again and try to get these Hornets another score. So we've got 11 minutes and 1 second left to somehow make a miraculous comeback for the Hornets.
Scored 94 points last week. We know he can score quickly and can score in droves. Two receivers to the left side now, one receiver to the right side. Birdwell has Keyshawn Walls behind him. Walls gets the handoff. Keyshawn Walls with some room in the middle. Slips down on the turf up across the 40. That's the second time we've seen somebody slip down. Hampton comes up to make the tackle. It'll be a 9-yard pickup on first down, second down and one. Now there's a flag that comes in from the umpire here late, and it might have been somebody mouthing a little bit.
Well, when you build a game up as big as this game has been built up, and pride gets hurt a little bit. Some chippiness coming out.
That's somebody mouthing a little bit, but now you take a second down and one, and you make it a second down and 14, or 16 rather, and that has to be extremely frustrating for the coaches here. You're trying to get something going here and get in trouble for saying something. Not sure what he said, but the umpire threw the flag pretty quickly, so it must have been something not very nice. Two receivers to the left side, one receiver to the right side. Birdwell looking left, tipped, incomplete. He was trying to connect with Logan Baker.
Pass was intended for number 13, Logan Baker, falls incomplete.
Yeah, Quinn Webb there, part of that breakup, and he and Hampton had a chance to possibly get an interception there.
Hornets back to the line now. Two receivers split to each side. Third down and 14 to go. Ball on the 33. Birdwell looks left. Pump fakes. Runs out of time, and he'll be brought down in the backfield. And another flag coming in a little bit late here. Got somebody from Dangerfield missing a hat.
Yeah, Marlon Hayes there for the stop there, bringing Ripken down for a loss.
Birdwell with the pump fake. He was trying to give his receiver some time to get open down the field. The pocket collapsed around him, and they were able to bring the sophomore down there. 14 seniors on this Hornet team. And so they'll know what's looking more and more like the final game for these young men.
After the play was over, dead ball, no foul, face mask, offense, number 60. That penalty will be enforced half to the goal from the end of the play. The down count, fourth down, number 50 of the defense may remain in the game as his helmet was removed by way of foul.
So a face mask penalty will take us back half the distance to the goal. And young man's helmet came off. And, Jay, I guess that's the first time I've heard that. If you lose your helmet on a play, you have to come out for a play, however.
Unless somebody jerks
They off. Said since it was by way
by
of penalty,
yes.
You do not have to come out for a play.
And I don't know who that whitehead is, but he explained it very well.
Yeah, it was easy to understand.
Jasper Crane going to be called on to punt.
This will be a high short punt. It will take a left turn and roll out of bounds inside the 35-yard line, down to about the 32, and so that's where the Tigers will have it, first down and 10 inside Hornet territory, and so a short punt there from Crane. 9:58 remaining in the ball game. Talk about some of these senior guys out here for the Hornets, Carvion Johnson, Braden Doyle, Emmanuel Baird, Traven Johnson, Kobe Ewing, Logan Baker, Jatavius Boogie Johnson, Keyshawn Walls, senior, who has had a fantastic season and career here at Hooks. Daniel Godfrey, Kaysen Schott, Tamarian Smith, Ransom Jones, River McCoy, Damian Vasquez, the 14 seniors out here for this Hornet team.
Yeah, outside of last week's game when they gave up 57 but scored 92, 22 points is the most that they've allowed until tonight.
Tigers in on offense once again, get it down to the 30-yard line.
Number three, Braden Lewis on the carry.
Bring up second down and about eight to go. Texas High has tied their game up in the third quarter. They are tied at 14. And so the Texarkana version of the Tigers trying to keep their season going, much like the Dangerfield version here with us. The Blue Tigers send three receivers to the left side, one to the right side for Chase Johnson and company. He wants to throw it out, get a little screen pass set up. It is complete to Kenny Mosley. Mosley's forward progress stops him inside the 30 at the 29-yard line.
Yeah, spins off the first defender, but R.K. Minter there to stop him after a 2.5, 3-yard gain.
That'll keep the clock rolling inside of 8:40. Remaining, it'll make it third down and 7 to go. And now Dangerfield slowing down, trying to burn as much time off that play clock and game clock as possible. 5 seconds now on the play clock as they snap it. Hand the ball off to Ashton Williams. He dives into the center of the defense. He'll be about a yard shy of the first down. Gets it inside the 25-yard line.
And just falls to the feet of Logan Baker there for the stop.
It'll be inside of 8 minutes when this one is snapped. You look over this Hornet roster, Jay, and you got a lot of sophomores out there that have had some pretty good playing time tonight. A lot of juniors out there as well. Next year you're going to be missing some big playmakers, but the cupboard is certainly not bare. And one of the things that helps you, you got a season like this, you go, you know, undefeated through the regular season, get into the playoffs, play in some of those games. That's extra football you get to practice, you know, each week. And that's kind of how you start to build programs. You see that in the programs around the area. The more you're in the playoffs, the more you're getting those extra practices, the more you're letting those young cats get some varsity experience on Friday nights. It helps you start to build your program as you go forward, and I really expect to see this Hooks program to continue to grow and to continue to excel.
Well, and tonight hurts, but I am super proud of Hooks. They've had a tremendous season. You know, when you go this far into the season without a loss, you've done some great things.
And a flag on this play is Dangerfield gets it snapped here.
Yeah, and kind of just go off what Jay said.
Yeah.
You know, these guys have, you know, they poured their hearts into it, nothing to be ashamed of. Second round of the playoffs, and they've done a tremendous job. Just unfortunate, you know, just the way football works.
Yeah, and really I think you could probably point to several plays tonight that just bounced one way or the other, and tonight it's just – it's very rare that everything bounces one direction, but tonight, Jay, it just kind of seems like that's what it was. The penalty will make it fourth down and 6 now for Dangerfield. 7.5 minutes remaining in the ball game. Two receivers to each side. Johnson drops back, firing down the field. Incomplete. That landed somewhere about lane 2 of the track.
Johnson has a cannon on him.
Yeah, he can fire it. The ball goes over on downs. I tell you, so you look at this region here in 3A, you got a West Rust team coming in next week. I feel like probably Dangerfield or Hooks, either one, would be a step up from that. You're going to have to contend with Newton at some point to try to get a trip over to Arlington, but this Dangerfield team tonight has been pretty impressive to me.
Yeah, I want this Dangerfield team to go on and go to Arlington.
If you're going to lose, you want to lose to the champion, right?
Right. I think just everybody they got on the field, all the tools that they've got, they've got what it takes.
Definitely have put together an impressive complete game tonight. The Hornets now back on offense, first down and 10 at the 28. Birdwell hands the ball off to Keyshawn Walls. be bottled up right near the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down and 10. I do want to say something about Damian Vasquez. You've got, you know, you talk about student athletes and these young men, they're not, you know, paid football players. You got to remember they do so many other things. This young man, not only out here playing as a senior on the football team, but he won the Regional Student Congress debate competition. And so you think about that, what that takes to be able to think on your feet, to communicate clearly, and he's going to head to the state competition in January. And so pretty cool. You see a young man out there that can go from the football field and then put on a suit and stand up and participate in student Congress and win some debate. And so we wish him luck as he heads down to the state contest in January. And that's the thing. These kids in high school these days, there are so many opportunities to shine in a variety of ways, be it academically, athletically, musically. And I think anybody in Hooks can be proud of the education that the students are receiving and the opportunities that are available and how that continues to grow. And just a fantastic school district doing some great things. Of course, Keith Minter, their superintendent over there, I think a guy with a good vision and a good desire to help that place grow. Second down and 10 now after the timeout for the Hornets. This time the handoff goes to
Kaysen May.
He is a sophomore running back out there. And, again, we talk about some of those young cats, getting them some time out here to run around. There's a flag on the play, though.
Hey, Matt, I want to go back real quick, back to Damian real quick. So all the kids, they call him Cheeto. That's his nickname.
Yep.
And when the Hooks had the 100-year celebration of ISD, you know, that really he's a talker. So him doing good at debate was no surprise to me.
Made some sense to you, right?
He is. If I don't know what he's going to end up doing in his life. I'll pause for a second.
Got an unsportsmanlike.
Who is that on?
Penalty on 64. Ransom Jones. And he's the one that got in trouble earlier, I think, for saying something. I'm not sure what happened on this one, but since it's the second one, that disqualifies you from the game, and so Orlando Steger is coming in for him. And that's the deal, buddy. You look out here, all the kids that play high school ball, all the kids that are in high school athletics, a small percentage of those get to go on and play college ball,
right,
and an exceptionally small percentage of those ever get actually paid to play something in athletics. And so what you learn out here about teamwork and camaraderie and working together and listening to instruction and getting better each week and taking personal accountability, that's the kind of stuff that's going to travel with these young men for years to come, and I know that's what makes this Hooks community proud of them. Handoff once again goes to Kaysen May.
Once again, Kaysen May.
Carries around the right side up near the 25-yard line. Picks up about 10 of the 15 penalty yards. It'll be third down now for the Hornets.
Yeah, Kaysen's going to be a bright star for Hooks. He's averaging a little over 7 yards a carry so far this season, so he's going to be somebody that Hooks can depend on once Keyshawn is gone, and makes a pretty big impact on the defensive side too. He leads the team in interceptions with 3.
Yeah, just a quick thing about him. You know, his first game where he actually started was against Paul Pugh, the first game of district, and his dad was all nervous, and we just happened to be standing there, and he got the pick 6, like, right off the start of the game.
Nice.
So I told his dad, I said, I don't think you got anything to worry about.
Birdwell on the quarterback keeper that time. Picks up a couple of yards. It's going to be fourth down.
Brings up a fourth down and 2.
This Dangerfield team continuing to do a good job of stringing out the Hornet offense. Amarion Simon-Jones making the tackle that time. And again, I expect this Dangerfield team to have a chance to come out of this region, Jay. They really showed me some stuff tonight. Jasper Crane, this time with a booming spiral punt. And it's going to be down inside the 20 for the Tigers, down near the 19. 4:57 remains in the ball game. Do want to remind you, though, tonight could not have happened without so many people in the Hooks community who stepped up to help us bring this to you tonight. And I know we didn't get the outcome we wanted, but we had a fantastic opportunity to highlight these Hooks players, the community, and the school. Just want to say thanks to Nash Electric, C&D Mechanical, the Downtowner Restaurant, Alpha Stone TXK, and Texarkana Ag Holdings. Thank you so much for helping us bring this game tonight and for what you do. And Hooks fans and the people that live in Hooks community, remember those names, these local businesses, these folks. Those are the ones that show up every day and do stuff for these kids, show up and invest in this community. And make sure you let them know how much you appreciate their support tonight and giving us the opportunity to bring you this game. And hopefully in the future, as we continue to grow this endeavor in broadcasting, we'll be able to bring you some more games and have more opportunities to highlight these kiddos. The Tigers have a delay of game penalty here. It'll back them up 5 yards. And I don't know if the play clock guy here is really quick or something, Jay, but there's been a lot of those penalties tonight.
Well, and there really hasn't been any lifting of the arms to restart that clock either when the ball's been late, you know, put down slowly.
Dangerfield now with some number two guys in here. This is number 16, C.T. Elkins. He's a freshman out there running the ball around from them. Thomas Lester, number 15. He's the backup quarterback. He's a senior. He's out there getting some play time. Out here on the left side of the Hornet defense, Logan Baker comes up to make that tackle. He's joined by Rod Bailey over here in the secondary. Boogie Johnson playing the free safety up over the top. They hand the ball off once again.
Number 16, C.T. Elkins on
to Elkins. Daniel Godfrey comes over from behind him, the senior. Brings him down from behind to be a loss of one on the play back to the 18-yard line. Third down and 11 now. And Godfrey did a good job of getting off of a block to pull the ball carrier down from behind.
Yeah, he's had 67 tackles going into this game, so he's definitely had a good season for these Hooks Hornets.
Tigers with 10 seconds on the play clock. They get this one snapped. Different ball carrier here, but he is going to be bottled up quickly as well. Damian Vasquez, we talked about him earlier. There's Cheeto coming in to make the tackle. He brings Palmer down for a loss of one on the play. So Cheeto might have been able to bring him down, then explain to him how he did it.
No gain on the play, brings up a fourth down.
Fourth down and 11, and the Tigers will punt, I think, for the first time this evening, Jay.
Yeah, Boogie Johnson back to see if he can create a little magic.
I think we're going to have a delay of game once again. Well, they're going to get a timeout in. Before that, and they were trying to get some folks out there. I think maybe at some of the starters who were over on the sidelines, and they forgot that they got to get out there for special teams. Dangerfield burns their first time out of the second half. There'll be 2:45 left when we get this one rolling. We do want to thank Pittsburgh ISD and their leadership for being great hosts tonight. This was a great playoff atmosphere and venue. And, again, anytime you come to a playoff game, one fan base is going to leave excited, one fan base is going to leave deflated.
Yeah, you're right. But, you know, I'll say this. Hey, these kids got nothing to really hang their heads about. They had a great season.
Absolutely.
You know, they fought hard. Just unfortunate, you know, somebody's got to win, and tonight Dangerfield's the one.
So the Tiger punt will be downed just inside Hooks territory at the 49-yard line. And the Hornets will have it from there, first and 10, 2:33 now remaining in the ball game. Still think statistically, buddy, this will go down as one of the best seasons for the Hornets.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, this finishes right up there in the top. 10-1. I mean, what more could you ask for?
Absolutely.
You know, hey, played hard. Kudos to the Dangerfield Tigers. You know, I hope they end up in Arlington. I'm probably going to be down there watching the PG Hawks, I hope. And because I'll be pulling for them against the Big Red Sea next week.
Birdwell and company with the snap. Handed off to Keyshawn Walls. Walls coming around the left side. Being pursued by several Tigers from behind. Of course, another thing not to forget, basketball season starting up for the Hornets last year. Made the trip all the way down to Austin. And you know that they are looking to continue the success that they had in basketball, and they'll get rolling on that. Maybe didn't want to start before Thanksgiving, but.
Well, Matt, that's a trip to San Antonio.
San Antonio now.
Yeah, oh, you're down there on the Riverwalk.
Oh,
yeah.
Nice.
And, it was something else, man. You know, I've stressed to anybody out there listening, if you've never been to Arlington to watch the state championship football games, it's worth the drive, worth the money.
Absolutely.
If you've never watched the state championship basketball games, it's worth the drive and worth the money.
Pretty good time, huh?
Oh, man, it is. Just to watch the kids compete.
And so we'll be keeping up with the Hornets as they head on through basketball starting up pretty soon.
And I'm a little biased with you, buddy. I'm interested to see Pleasant Grove beat the Big Red Sea next week as well at 2 o'clock.
Well, you know, just like Jay, you know, we've talked about this, you know, and I guess it kind of rubbed off on me a little bit. You know, PG used to be our rival back in the day when I was in school. But being around you, supporting them guys, actually meeting them guys, hey, you know, K-Mac, Akari, Lance, they're all just great kids.
Well, and I think that's something really good to keep in mind. You look around, and I think that's one thing that Texarkana Game Day has done is allowed so many fan bases to see so many other schools and the kids that are there and give these kids an opportunity for exposure and to be seen. And they show up at walk-ons, and we've had the Hooks take over there at walk-ons before as well. But, man, you can just be fans of kids from around the area, and you really see that we are blessed in Northeast Texas just to have some incredible talent athletically. And so it's been really good to see that going. Birdwell's pass falls incomplete. And the Tigers will just need a kneel down to close this one out from here. So, again, not the result that we wanted as Hooks fans. This final will be 33-6 in favor of Dangerfield. And the Hornets just sort of ran into a buzzsaw here at Pittsburgh tonight. But like you say, nothing to hang your hat on. 10-1 season. A season with some ups and downs. Season with some big scores. And one that will go down in the record books. Keyshawn Walls, I think somebody that folks around Hooks and around Bowie County will talk about for quite some time, Jay. Boogie Johnson as well. And we look forward to see those young men as they move on to the college level as well. And then Arian Hampton, who's headed to Texas next year, I think tonight showed us a little bit about why he is recruited as highly as he has been.
Yeah, very outstanding on the defensive side. And then on the offensive side, Chase Johnson, what a pleasure to watch.
Yep.
And then Williams in the running back role, just absolutely phenomenal tonight. And kudos to Dangerfield. Wish them the best. And hopefully they'll be able to continue marching until deep into December.
So that's going to do it for us here. Reminder, you can catch the Texas High Tigers on game day each week as they head on and move in the playoffs. They're in a dogfight over there. You can see how they're doing. And the Pleasant Grove Hawks will be taking on Carthage next Friday, 2 o'clock p.m. That game is down in Pine Tree. The game will be broadcast on NFHS. You will have to subscribe to NFHS to see that broadcast, but we will be bringing you the game as the Texarkana Game Day crew. Want to once again thanks all the sponsors for tonight's game, Nash Electric, C&D Mechanical, the Downtowner Restaurant, Alpha Stone TXK, and Texarkana Ag Holdings. Your final from Pittsburgh, 33-6. The Hornets bowing out in the area rounds of the playoffs. Buddy, Thanks for joining us.
And, I appreciate y'all having me, and I appreciate Texarkana Game Day, and it's been a good time.
We'll see you around. Good luck to the Tigers as you head on into the state playoffs, and hopefully we'll see you down in Arlington. And be sure to check out Texarkana Game Day and everything we have coming up as we continue to highlight area players from around.
Speaking of Tigers, Texas High is now up 17-14 with less than 5 minutes remaining in the game, and we are streaming that tonight. So as you spin off of this stream, go check them out and watch and see if they can hold on to that win with just 5 minutes remaining in the game.
So switch over to that, Facebook or YouTube.
And, Matt, I'd like to say just one time, as a Hooks guy, appreciate our sponsors one more time for supporting the Hooks and getting this aired.
Yep, and just let those guys know how much you appreciate what they do. That's going to do it for us here. We will see you in the future, and go Hornets.